Hello everyone, I'm X13 and welcome back to the Aeroteam channel. In this tutorial, I'll be teaching you how to build the Airbus A380 in 1-to-1 scale. Now this build is in 1-to-1 scale, which means that 1 meter in real life equals exactly 1 block in Minecraft. This aircraft will scale perfectly with all of our other 1-to-1 tutorials on the channel, as well as your own 1-to-1 scale builds. As always, this aircraft does make use of our very own Aeroteam texture pack. A download link to the latest version, which at the time of recording is pre-release number 2, can be found on our website aeroteam.org/resource-pack. If you can't download the pack for whatever reason, I will give some tips to convert it into default, but you know, this aircraft was designed with the pack on, so just keep in mind that it might not look perfect. As for dimensions, this aircraft is 74 blocks long, 77 blocks wide, and 24 blocks tall. This tutorial is going to be pretty interesting to make, so yeah, we'll see how I do. Anyways, let's get building. Alright, so getting started with the front of the aircraft, we can come down to wherever you want the nose of the aircraft to be, and you can see the nose right over there. So just to start off here, I'm going to go 3 blocks up in the air, and then place a quartz top slab just on the side of that block. Now, I think this might be the first tutorial started off with a quartz slab instead of a purple slab. But nevertheless, purple slab will be the second block placed, and here we are. One purple slab back from that quartz slab, and just extend that out to either side to make it 3 blocks wide. And then we're going to go back with this 12 blocks in all. So we've already got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Now, that last block here, we're actually going to delete and replace that with a quartz stair facing forwards, like so, upside down. If it was right side up, it would look a little bit weird. Yeah, and then we can continue back here. We're going to come back again with a purple slab and make this 5 wide. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like so. Now we can get out our birch trapdoors. And let's see, that should be the last of the quartz slab that we need. So birch trapdoors out. We just place 2 of those in a row on either side here. And then in the center here, just fill that up with purple slabs. These are for a small air vent on the side. You can see it just there. It's covered up kind of by the front of the wing root right there. But yeah, that's for, I think, for probably bleed air. Actually, no, bleed air would come from the engines. But yeah, it's probably for like a compressor or something. Yeah, I don't know all the ins and outs of the A380, though I did do a fair amount of research before this video because I like providing little fun facts about the aircraft as I build it. And we'll get to the first one of those pretty soon. But anyways, from the side of this trapdoor, we're just going to place a purple slab on either side, like so, to make the 7 wide in all. And then what we can do is come in 2 purple slabs on the side, like so. And then with your white wool, you can fill up the middle like so. And now that's going to be the front of the wing box here. Now, coming back again with your white wool, just place one in the center here and make this 5 blocks wide. We're going to make this a 5 by 10 block space here of white wool. So we've already got 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And then we can just fill it up like this. Oops. And then just come into the center here and fill this all up. Just like so. All right. Now, extending these purple stairs back, this would be a row of 12 in all, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. That should line up with the back of the wing box there. And same thing on the other side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Alright, continuing back now, this is only the front part of the wing box. As you can see, the wing hasn't even, like, ended yet. The one kind of funny thing that I kind of find kind of funny about the A380 is like half of the bottom of the aircraft is wing box. Like literally the wing box only stops there, and then that's the end of the bottom. So you've got pretty much the front section, the wing box, and like a tiny little stub of the end, and we'll see that in a second as I build that out. But yeah, one little detail before we continue back, you can get your jungle buttons out, and on this last row of five, place two on either side, or sorry, one on either side, two in all, and that should be parallel with the aircraft, so make sure that you place them like this and not like that. This is a white button in the Aeroteam texture pack. You could use either jungle or stone in default, but yeah. Alright, continuing on back, we're now going to have a row of seven white wall blocks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And then, now here's where we get to kind of the interesting part. This is where the gear bays are. Now most of you might know that the A380 has four different wheel trucks. And I think it's, other than the 747, one of the only aircraft to ever have that. So the gear bays are pretty massive. The details in these are pretty, crazy. I don't know how they managed to fit all this into this tiny, space here. But yeah, so I'll try my best to, build all that out for you guys. So, first off, in the center here, we're going to make a 3x7 white wool block area, so 1, 2, 3, and then come back 7, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Maybe you can just fill that in real quick. Just make sure that's 7. Yep, okay. Now, we can come back again one more and just make this 7 blocks wide. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And just like that, you should have kind of this shape. In the center. Now this is where gear wells are going to be. For this, we'll need our quartz stairs. Shouldn't have gotten rid of those. And a dark oak button, which is the red button in the resource pack. And your purple stairs. Alright, so to get started here, first we're going to get our quartz stairs out. Place two facing outwards like this. And then one cornered off like so, and then come in like this from the other side. Now this looks a little bit weird right now, and I'll explain that in a second. And for the second row here, place one, then a purple stair, and then fill this all the way back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blocks back. Now, because this stair's here, that means that this stair can't actually be like this. So I'm going to be using some world edit in order just to create the stair shape like so. If you don't have rolled it, you can just leave it like this, and it's completely fine. You're probably never going to go in here anyways. But yeah, it's just a little bit of extra detail that we like to add. So you can corner this off like here, leaving this blank, and then if you've got rolled it, you can get your wooden axe, or your wand, I suppose it's not really a wooden axe. You can get that by typing /wand, and then enter, and it'll give you one. Now you can just left-click and right-click on the stair just to select only this block, and then first you want to make sure you're facing in the direction you want it to go. So we're standing over here and facing this way because we want it to stack this way. And type /stack, and because we're only doing it one block, we can just leave it as this. And there we go. If you're going to stack it more than that, you would have to put in a number, but just because it's one, it'll automatically assume that it's one, and it'll just stack it there. And there we go. So, just for some final details here, with our dark oak buttons, so this is technically impeding on layer 2, whatever. We can place a temporary block here and here on either side of this white wool stair, and then here, which is one block from the end. Get your dark oak button out, and a stick or any tool, type /REPL and 0, hit enter on that, and it'll say block replacer tool bound to stick or something similar like that. You can left-click on the button now, and then delete it, and then, with your stick, just right-click on all three of these blocks, and then I'll paste it over. Now you might see somewhere your lighting glitches, so I'm just going to do /highlight really quick, and that'll either, okay, there we go, and that fixes some of those lighting issues. Alright, we can do the same thing on the other side here. I'm going to do this one a little bit faster, just because you kind of just copy it over. So anyway, we got these two stairs here, corner it off, there we go. Three here, and then a full row across the front. Select this stair back here, and do /stack, like so. Temporary blocks, temporary blocks there. And then I've still got that button selected, so I can just paste those over like so. Now we can come out with our purple slabs from this block right here and just come out one on either side. And then we're going to take this back two, so just like that. So one, two, and then we got your quartz slabs. Just place one of those right there and then bring it back seven more. So one, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. And that'll go one further back than what this is currently at. So same over here, one, two, with the quartz slab, and then one, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. And I just realized that I actually forgot to put a white wool stair here instead of a quartz stair, so there we go. Just replace that over real quick. Oh yeah, that's just a little reminder. Make sure to do that white wool stair there. All right, continuing on now, we can place, let's see here, your purple slabs and just come in one like so, and then five white wool blocks in a row in the center there. Now, let's see, we've got, all right, we've got, if you want to come back one more on, coming in from this purple slab layer, and then let's see, come back one more with those to make it a row of two. Come in with each of those to make it a 2x3, like so. And then we're going to place a block here. And I believe if I check real quick, because I can't remember. Let's see here. Okay. So actually, this should not be here. It should just be two slabs, like so. All right, moving on from that, now you can get out your stone slabs. Kind of an odd block, I know, but you'll see why in a reason, or in a second, not a reason. Just place one of those in the center there, and five wide like so. Now that is for this small gray stripe kind of at the back of the aircraft here. Not really sure why that's there, actually. I think it might mark out where one of like the separation marks is for the fuselage, if you don't know they build like the fuselages in sections, kind of like that. Not as many as that, but you know, the nose is in one section, kind of the wing areas in one section, and the tail is in one section usually, and that might just mark out like where one of those sections ends. Yeah, I'm not fully sure on that, but that's kind of my theory. Anyways, we can actually come one forward here and just delete this block here, catch out your quartz stairs, and place another one facing forward like so. That's just for that little antenna sticking out of the bottom of the aircraft right there. Moving on, get out your quartz, or sorry, not quartz, purple slab again, and just do a row of five across the back, then a row of three, and then two on the outside, plus another quartz stair like so, facing forwards, upside down, and just one more purple slab at the back. And that will do it for what is technically layer one. However, instead of doing this on layer 2, I'm going to do it now, just because it makes it a lot easier. First, we're just going to get our, let's see, oh yeah, I didn't do that. So get your jungle button out, and your dark oak button. And first off, we're going to come two blocks behind where this quartz slab is. So one, or sorry, actually, that one again. So one, two, right here, and come into the center here. But you gotta go under, so the center would be right here, and place a red button again. That's for the beacon light on the bottom, and then go two blocks back, and just one more jungle button right there. Again, if you're in default, you can use a stone button or a birch button. Yeah, so coming up to the front here again, we can get your stone buttons and stone pressure plates out. And now this is gonna be some details for the, I'm forgetting the name of them now. How do I forget the name of this? The freight areas, the cargo holds. There we go. So anyway, come three blocks back on this third one, and just place a pressure plate, stone button, and just kind of alternate back until we reach, let's see. If you come out to, yeah, so one, two, three, four of these slabs back and into the center, and that one will be your last pressure plate. I think. Let's hope. So yeah, so just kind of fill this in. So alternating between pressure plate and button. So pressure plate, button, 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 pressure plate. And there you go, that's for the front cargo hold. That's just kind of for the details of those like rails on the bottom that they can slide those ULD containers down. And at the back here as well, we are gonna go, let's see, we can start from just in front of the gear holds. If you didn't know, kind of an interesting fact about the A380 is that, as I was saying before, because there's so little space on the bottom of the aircraft after the wing box, because it basically starts sloping up immediately after, the cargo hold, or at least the real cargo hold, actually comes in between the gear bays. So kind of an interesting little fact. But yeah, so we can start off with a pressure plate here, and that's just one block in front of these stairs here. And then do the same thing all the way back to that last block right there. So pressure plate button, and I'm not gonna keep saying it because that is quite annoying. And there we go. All right, and that should fully do it for layer one. This took me way longer than I thought it would, but I suppose I should have expected that because it is an A380. Anyways, on to layer two. All right, so starting on layer two now, this is a bit confusing at the front end here. I actually ended up confusing myself just now, but it ended up being alright. So anyway, we're first going to come down to the block in between this quartz slab and this pressure plate, and just place one quartz pillar. That's for the end of the cargo bay, and yeah, that's just to add a little bit of texture there. Now on either side, we can add some white wool. And just bring these two blocks more forward. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Now with your purple slabs, we can get just put one of those on the front, just like that. Then our quartz slabs, place two half slabs in this gap here, and just one top slab right there. And that will be the front. Now that's kind of the most confusing part. This layer is gonna be interesting because there's a lot of like just random blocks kind of in the middle to section everything off, like for the cargo bays and the gear holds and everything, or cargo holds and gear bays, yes. Yes, but anyway. So we can come out to the side here and just place two purple top slabs. These are gonna go 11 blocks back. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And that's only on the left side. On the right side here, going to come back 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, get your quartz, place one purple slab, and then one quartz slab, and then switch back to your purple and go back 3 blocks more, just like so, and that should end you in the same place. Now for the inside here, we're not going to be using blocks like usual, we're actually going to be using slabs, just to give the cargo hold a little bit more space. Anyway, on the right side here, we can put four purple slabs down, then a row of three quartz slabs, and then 10 more purple slabs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That should land you with that pressure plate there. And then on the left side, we can do 17 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 15. Yep. 16 and 17. At the back here, you can get out your quartz pillars again and just place three more of those. Also make sure you're placing these vertically because they can go like that as well. And that's not what we want, so we got them vertically. But yeah, anyways, at the side here with these slabs, get your blocks out and just come back 7 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And that should land you diagonally with those pillars. Same thing on this side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and 7. Now, off to the side here, two blocks back from this first one here, so 1, 2, and then on this third one here, that should be just above that trapdoor, we place 12 blocks going back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. And that happens on both sides as well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Alright, now what we can do is place a 2x4 of blocks right here, or not a 2x4, sorry, 2x2, 1 and 2 like that, so just a little square right there, and that happens on both sides. And then from the rear one of these, we can just come one block in, like so. I know this is going to get a little bit confusing, but it will all make sense in the end, I promise. You can come one forward from that, and three quartz pillars again, like so. And then, with your white wool again, we're going to come 10 blocks back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And then we can get out our stone brick walls. And let's see here. Actually, we're not going to do that quite yet. First, we're going to skip these two blocks here, this quartz slab and purple slab, and just behind it, place one block of wool, one stone slab, and then go back six more blocks of wool. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and that will happen on both sides. So skip those two, one stone slab, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. All right, now we can come in one with the blocks here, and then go forward three. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That should just cover up those four slabs here. And there's another look if you're getting confused. And then coming back here, we're actually going to place just one in the space right here. And that's just for the end of the gear base there. Now we can get out our stone brick walls and just place two of those right there. Those should be lined up. Just the front one will be with the stone slab, and the back one just behind it, just like so. Alright, I know this is quite confusing, although there's not too much left, so you're doing good. After this row of 10 white wool blocks, we're then going to switch to our white wool slabs and make a layer of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, and that should overhang by 1. And do that on both sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. All right. Actually, sorry. This doesn't happen on the right side. Never mind. Instead, we're going to do a row of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then 2 quartz slabs. And we'll leave it like that for now. Come back to that in a minute. And then let's see here. We've got 4 down. Okay, so now, just behind this block here, we're going to place a stone full block, and then come back one more with a white wool. Again, on this side, stone block, and just a block of white wool there. And then we are going to skip this block here, and then just where the slab starts, place a row of 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Alright, now with our purple slabs, just 2 top slabs right there, and there we go, we're getting there. And actually, again, that doesn't happen on the right side, it should just be 1 quartz slab and then 1 purple slab, as you get this kind of like backwards L shape with the quartz so far, and the 707's over there actually. Go watch that tutorial if you haven't. I did that one as well. In fact, I've done a lot of airliner tutorials. But yeah, anyways, coming back again in the center here. Sorry, my notes are getting a little bit confusing. You can go into the center here and then two in all, just like that. On this, let's see, what is that? Okay, so there should be 1 white wool on the left side here, like so, and then a purple stair facing backwards, and then 2 slabs like so. So that'll be like that. On the right side here, we have 1 quartz full block. I'm actually gonna have to look that up because it's a different texture. Quartz full block right there. Purple slab again, not a quartz stair. Or sorry, not purple slab. Quartz purple stair right here, not a quartz stair. And then a quartz slab right here. And then just come one more back with the purple slabs. Now, in the right in the center where this quartz slab is, we can come back, come in one and then out 3. So 1, 2, 3. That should do it. Let's see if I missed anything, because it's pretty likely in a layer as complicated as this. But you can kind of see how as the gear bay goes in between the, or sorry, as the cargo hold goes in between the gear bays, it gets a little bit narrower. It doesn't actually, it just goes from slab to slab to full block. Oh, but in real life, it does actually get narrower. Oh, it's just we've only got one block to work with here, so not a lot that we can do. Anyways, that should be enough. So on, actually, there is one more detail. I always forget the little details. I have to re-record the whole layer after that, so that's not fun. If you do have roller tent, you can get out a torch. Now, the torch in the Aeroteam texture pack is kind of like a sea lantern texture. It's even animated, which is kind of cool. But yeah, if you come on the right side here, and just one block in front of this quartz slab here, you just place a temporary block, and you can do that on both sides here, with a torch on it. And then we can just use our stick from, you should still have that replace stick from when we did those buttons. So just left click and right click again. And just like so. Obviously you only do that with roller dip, but shouldn't worry about it. If you don't have it, it's not that big of a detail. And those are, I believe, are the runway turnoff lights, or just like the, yeah, the runway turnoff lights, because they just kind of, the taxi light illuminates kind of this area here, and these illuminate sort of this side area, so when you're landing, you can see how the yellow line kind of follows the runway center line out of the runway. Oh yeah, anyway, on to layer 3. Alright, so for layer 3 now, you can come up to the front of the aircraft here, and just come out one block like that, and that is the very tip of the nose. We got to it a lot faster than usual. Mostly based on the fact that the nose of the A380 is so stubby. Anyways, moving on, we can now come out by one on each side, and then make these rows of three blocks back, like so. In the middle here, I'm just going to put one quartz pillar, and then a stone brick stair upside down facing forward, like that, and then a polished diorite top slab right behind that. On either side of that, just one quartz pillar, like so. And there we go. Now, just kind of out to the side of that stone brick stair, we can place our purple top slabs, like so. And there is a little bit of roll of detailing that you can do with that. Just destroy all this stuff now, because I no longer need it. You can add a stone button on either side to this slab. So we just place a block at either side. Button on it, and just rolled edit that over, and delete the original. And there we go. Now we can go back with our blocks 14. So, on the left side only, not the right side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. That should land you just right there. On the right side, however, we're going to go 6 back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That should land you right where the cargo bay, cargo hold doors are. And then we're going to do 2 full blocks of quartz, just like that, separated by a single block of white wool. And back from that, 5 more blocks of white wool. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 5. All right. Let's see here. Okay, so moving on now, we can, let's see, come to the fourth block in this row 14, and on that fourth block, just place one purple slab, and then we're going to go 11 slabs back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11, and that should land you even with it. On the right side, however, we're still going to come four back, sorry, so 1, 2, 3, 4. And then here we've got, actually, sorry, I counted that wrong, 1, 2, 3, 4 on that fourth block. Place that slab, 1, 2, 3. And then we're going to do a row of, let's see, quartz slabs, like so, just three across like that. And that'll finish off that cargo door. And then five more purple slabs, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. All right, so now what we can do is have another, another row of 14 blocks, except for that now we are one block more out. So starting right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. Now from the side of that, we're actually going to come forward. Don't see that every day, huh? Especially not in these plane tutorials. So from out here, just 1, 2, 3, and 4. And you should have this curve right here. This is for the wing, so on A380s and A350s and a lot of Airbus aircraft actually, there's this kind of like So this is the wing box, but it actually, like, comes out of the aircraft. Most of the time, it's kind of just, like, you know, like that, as you may know. But yeah, on A380s and A350s, especially on the A350, on the A380, it's a little bit more subdued. But yeah, the A350 is really the biggest, or the easiest to see example of this. But yeah, you can see how the wing box actually comes out a little bit. And then, yeah, so that's where that stops. And then it kind of goes into the wing right there to emerge right there. Yeah, and that's painted white, not the gray wing color, so that's why I'm building it now, because it's just a little bit easier. So yeah, so we got that row of four, and then two purple top slabs back from that, and then five hole blocks. One, two, three, four, and five. And then just behind that, just to finish this off, two more slabs. Alright, now to take a little break from the back here, we're just going to come in to the gear holds, and this will be the last thing that we do with the gear holds, so you're lucky on that part. First, we're just going to do, let's see here. So starting at the back here, we can, I got confused there for a second there. We're going to start at this block right here and just come out to, like so, into the center here. And then this second block here will be extended 9 blocks back. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, like so. And then you can come in again. Now, with your diorite slabs on here, this first three here, we can make into diorite top slabs. Two diorite blocks just above those stone brick walls, and then two more diorite top slabs. Now, again, if you have rolled it, there is a couple more details that we can add in here. If you have your lever on you, which you probably don't because you haven't used it before, but you can get your lever out, and just place it like this, and then select that right there, place two temporary blocks, and just paste that over right there. And that should be in this sort of space here. And let's see, so now what we're going to do is just fill out the rest of this, the not diorite part. So we've got a row of five purple top slabs, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then five blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and that should go right above that stone block right there. Now we can do this on the other side real quick, just because we're going to need to do it eventually. So starting all the way up here, because I just realized I haven't done any of this, 14 blocks back, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. Just to make sure that it's 14, because I might have miscounted. 14. And we can come back 4 forward, like so. And then now we are going to come back with those two purple top slabs, and then five more wavel blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then two more purple half slabs. Now you can get out your diorite again. Start here, come to one in the middle, make this 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Come in again. And then actually I'm gonna do this row of five right now. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, just to make it easier on ourselves. Same with this purple slabs here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then right here, we can do our two diorite hole blocks just on top of those walls there, and then just half slabs in the gaps. All right, now we can just place some temporary blocks there, lever flipped facing downwards, and faster. Now you might notice when you paste these on the black green light, and it'll either take like 2 minutes and 3 seconds, or a really short amount of time, and just like that. All right, let's see. Am I missing anything here? Not anymore. All right, continuing back then, on the left side here, we can place, let's see, that should be, find that five, so that would be, let's see, actually, first we're going to come in and do our row of seven here, so one, and that is directly to the side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then a purple stair facing like so, and two full slabs, sorry, to the side of that stair. We're going to go block back four blocks back from the side of the stair, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then a perper stair, and then two perper slabs. Let's see, from this block here, just cover this area in with white wool, including that stair right there, and then just one more perper stair, and two more perper slabs. All right, this area is confusing me a little bit, actually. Let's just check real quick. Okay, got it. All right, so this should be a proper upside down stair, just like we've been doing, and then just two half slabs, top slabs like that. All right, now for the other side, this is going to be a little bit different, again, because of the cargo hold, and as well as the bulk cargo door, which means that we should actually get this out. I'll explain what that is in a second, as well as that. All right, so again, from the side of this block, not out diagonally to the direct side, three blocks back this time. And then out to the side, we have a perper stair, like so, one perper slab, and then we have, just behind here, three blocks of quartz and one quartz slab out to the side. So that should look like that. All right, behind that, we just got one more white wool. And then let's see here, that would be another perper stair and two more slabs. And then out to the side of the stair, we've got one block of wool. Bring that back four blocks, one, two, three, four, stair and two more slabs, just like so. Yeah, that got confusing in there. If you need another look at the top here, got it. I'll give you guys a couple different views, just so you make sure you get that correct. Just pause it at any time if you need to look at it again, as well as like the side view here. But yeah. All right, and for one final detail on this, we're just gonna get out our prismarine brick stairs, which are green stairs in the Aeroteam texture pack, and green in default, actually. So you can use this in both. And just in between these first two blocks here, just place one. Just like that. And that's for the bolt cargo door here. There's like a little green net here to prevent the the bolt cargo, which is like the suitcases and stuff, from like kind of moving into like the ULD container area. I should forget what ULD stands for. It's like universal loading something. I forget. I know it's universal something. Or at least I'm pretty sure. Not fully sure. Oh yeah, anyway, that's just like a little green net. And yeah, that should do it for layer 3. This is a very large tutorial. Yeah, this is taking me a little bit longer than I thought. Yeah, on to layer 4. Alright, so for layer 4 now, we can come up to the front of the fuselage here, and just place another block on top of that tip of the nose there. Come back two more blocks, and then three more. Just like so, on both sides. This might be the easiest layer in the whole thing, because we're kind of in between the windows and, like, the slopey area. So, should be the easiest, except maybe that one, or that one. But yeah, this is going to be one of, if not the easiest ones. Anyways, in this kind of corner here, you can place just two stone buttons on either side, like so. Now get out your block of quartz, and come out like this on either side. And then back with your white wool, come back nine blocks. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. And one block of quartz. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. And one block of quartz. Now come back 15 blocks. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. And a block of quartz. And both sides, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and a block of quartz. Now come back 11 blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and a block of quartz on both of those. 5 more blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and a block of quartz on there. And actually, sorry, no blocking quartz on those. Got a little bit caught up in it. Now what we're gonna do is get out your birch trapdoors, which are a white wool trapdoor texture in the Aeroteam pack. Geez, iron if you're in default. Anyways, You can go two purple topsails back and a birch strap door on the end there. Same on both sides. Now on the insides there to cover up these holes, you can do a purple slab at the beginning there, and then stairs facing forwards like this, and then just a full block. Then we're gonna have our block of quartz, right there. And then let's see here, we've got, got a little discrepancy there. Let's see which is correct. Let's see, we've got, okay, so we should have two full blocks behind each door, and then a purple slab. On the inside of this here, we're just going to have purple slabs on both sides. Over on the right side, you can have one purple stair facing inwards like this. I believe this is for a piece of the interior. We'll get to that later. But yeah, that's just a precursor for now. Now we can get out our white wool, and from these slabs here, come back two. So one, two, and one, two. And then we've got our purple slabs. Start in between here and come back one more. And then just come up one. And then make a U shape out of that with slabs, sort of like that. And for the final block here, we're just going to place a quartz upside down stair facing backwards. And that will do it for that whole layer. So that was nice and easy. Alright, so now for layer 5. We can come down to the nose of the aircraft and come in one block, as we are already on the part of the nose that starts coming back into the fuselage. Out diagonally on either side and back two, and same thing again. Now for some details, with your stone button, you can just place one stone button on top of this. I'll make sure it's perpendicular to the aircraft because there are two ways to place them. So you want this wider one. And then as well, you can place, once I actually place this down, a slab here. And just select your buttons with those, and you can paste that over as well if you have more of it. Just like so. Alright, so that there should be three of those. It should be kind of like a sideways T shape with that. Alright, moving on now to the doors and windows, or at least the first set of them, which I guess this is the first time we've ever done a double decker on this channel, so we'll see how this goes. Anyways, we can start it off with our quartz stairs here. And the way that I decided that I'm going to do is I'm just going to go all the way down the left side and then all the way down the right side, just because I don't want to have to be like jumping back and forth every time. So anyway, upside down quartz stair facing backwards. Now we're going to have a row of 8 purple stairs facing backwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then we're going to have a full block of white wool, a quartz stair facing backwards, and another full block of white wool. Now we're going to have 13 purple stairs facing backwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Block of white wool, quartz stair, and then directly into a row of 10 purple stairs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Block of white wool, quartz stairs facing backwards there. Block of white wool, and then now what we're going to do is have a row of 7 blocks, or 7 purple stairs facing forwards, but because I don't want to have to go like that every time I want to place one, instead let's just count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, place a temporary block right there, and then you can just go forward like so. And there we go. That's what also the reason why this trapdoor was here, is because if it's not, you get that, which doesn't look very good, as opposed to that. Moving on, we can place our quartz stair facing backwards yet again. And then that looks like a row of, let's see, just to check, 4 white wool blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 in, and then get out your smooth stone. Smooth stone stairs, and your smooth stone slab. Now what we're going to do with this, this is just for the elevator trim. You can see it right there. So you can place three smooth stone blocks, and then a smooth sandstone stair. That's a tug twister. Smooth sandstone stair, and a smooth stone slab. If you are in default, you won't have a smooth stone stair. It's the smooth sandstone stair in the Aeroteam pack. However, you will have like maybe a stone stair that you can use there, or just do something like that. I don't know. I'll actually just use a stair of a different texture because it's better to mess up the texture than the layering. All right, moving back now, we can do a, let's see, just one purple slab in the middle and a quartz slab at the end there. I believe that's for the beginning of the APU door, access door, yep, looks like it. And then just to the center here, just two purple stairs to block up that gap right there. All right, now we can come back all the way to the front and do that all again. Okay, so quartz stair facing backwards, and we have a row of, gotta look at this again, eight stairs facing backwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Full block of white wool, quartz stair facing backwards, full block. Row of 13, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Block of white wool, quartz stair facing backwards, and then directly into the row of 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. I'll follow the end there. White wool, quartz stair, and then let's see here, and then we've got one more row of 7, and that's facing forward, so you get the block. And then we can just come back to here, place a temporary block, and purple stairs facing forwards. Oops. There we go. And now just that quartz stair facing backwards there. Four blocks of white wool, one in diagonally, and then three full blocks of smooth stone, one smooth sandstone stair facing backwards, upside down, and a smooth stone top slab. Alright, and that should do it, yes, for layer, what was that, layer 5. Alright, now onto layer 6 here. We're first going to start up here at the nose with the cockpit windows. So, come one up and place a slab, just like so. And come out diagonally on either side, and then back one off of each of those. On the sides of these, you can just place slabs, as that opening is only going to be 2 blocks wide. Behind those, just place 2 blocks, and then just lengthen those back by one. And now, possibly the most boring layer in the history of the Aeroteam. Although, in the case of this aircraft, boring is good, because, oh man, this is taking way longer than I thought. We're on layer 6, and we're only about halfway done. So, first, we're going to come out diagonally from this row of 2, and go back 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then on this fifth block here, we're going to place a not stone button, a jungle button. And then, yeah, jungle button. Or actually, no. Is that a stone button? Yes, it is. Okay, never mind. Stone button. Now, from this block right here, we're going to come back 8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And on that ninth block back, a jungle sign. This is a white sign in the Aeroteam texture pack. If you don't have it, I guess just use like birch. Now we're going to go back 18 blocks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. And on that 19th block, another sign. Now we're going to go back 8 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. On that ninth one, again, jungle sign. Now we're going to go back 3. 1, 2, not quartz. 1, 2, 3. And then a purple slab with a top slab on the inside, like so. 5 blocks back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then in 1. And then we're going to get out our smooth stone. And we can place 2 of those right there. I'm going to start doing this on both sides now because it's pretty small. 5 blocks back, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then right here, we're going to place 2 blocks of white wool, 2 blocks of quartz, 1 purple slab, and 1 quartz slab. And this is just for the APU access doors. You can see them right there. And actually, sorry, this shouldn't be a quartz slab. That should be a smooth stone slab. And that's for the bottom of the APU. It's kind of hard to see there. There you go. But yeah, we can just do this on the other side real quick now. So, coming back to the front here, we're going to go back four blocks out. 1, 2, 3, 4. And on that fifth one, let me just get this stuff out again. On that fifth one, stone button. Now to go 8 blocks back, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and on that ninth one, jungle sign. Now 18, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and jungle sign. And then 8 blocks back, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then on the ninth one, another jungle sign. And then now we can just go 3 blocks back, or sorry, did I mess this up? Quite possibly, let's see, it should be 8, yes, that should be 17, okay, that's where I messed up, I accidentally went back, 17, not 18, gotta be careful of that, because that will probably happen to you, so just make sure to double check all this stuff, because if you get this wrong, the whole layer will be off, which would not be good. Yeah, anyways, coming back, 3 more blocks, and a purple slab here, and then a top slab on the inside, just like that, 5 blocks back, just like so, and because I already built the rest of this, that is it for layer, what is this, layer 6, so yeah, now onto the upper deck regions, which will be fun, first time in history of this channel, to do that. It's kind of weird because, like, the cockpit's on there, but it's still, like, you haven't started going in yet. Looks kind of weird. Anyway, I'll stop procrastinating and get on with layer 7. Okay, now starting on layer 7. Apologies if I'm a little bit rusty on this. It's been about 3 weeks since I recorded the first part of this, so, but yeah, we're gonna try and continue here. So starting with your snow here, on these first three top slabs here, we're just going to place two layers of snow on each of those, and then right behind that, just full blocks, just like so, and that kind of creates that large forehead that the A380 does have. Moving back now, on the left side here, the side that I'm currently on, what we're first going to do is place a top slab just behind this block, and then a half slab out to the side of that, and then come back two blocks with your white wool, and a purple slab out to the side, I believe so, yep. Now, we're going to pause here because this is where the sides do get a little bit different, so we'll just be coming over to the other side real quickly, and doing the same thing here at first with that top slab behind this block, and then the half slab out to the side of that. Then we're going to be placing three blocks of wool behind that one, and then a purple slab just here, and you can leave this one blank for now. So continuing on, this is where we're going to start the upper deck doors. You can see them right there. This is like kind of in between two layers, so it'll be a bit interesting as to how we actually get those in, but you'll see soon enough. So coming back on the left side here first, we've got our 12 purple slabs on this side, or sorry, actually we've got, let's see here, yes, 12 on this side. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12, and there we go. However, from this block, we're only going to come back 11, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, like so. Now, sorry, I'm just checking my notes here real quick. Alright, sorry about that. First, what we're actually going to do, I got a little bit confused there. If you just come back to this point, where we've got just the three blocks on the right side and the two on the left. Now, starting on the left side, we can come back from these blocks with one half slab, and then directly out to the side like this. So it's this slab is one further back than it was previously. Now, from both of these, we can come back 12 blocks, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12, And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And that should land you just one in front of this sign. Now on the other side here, it's going to be a little bit different. For this bottom layer, it won't be, so you can just place your first slab here and come back 12 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. However, for the upper layer, we're going to only go back 11 because of this extra block. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And that should make it all even. Alright, continuing back now, we've got our first upper door right there. So just to start that off, we can just place a half slab here and a coarse upside down stair facing inwards, like so. And just do that on both sides, like so. Coming back again, now we have 18 of this sort of pattern here with the half slab and then top slab on both sides, so we can come back like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Again, that should be one in front of that sign. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. And just do that on the other side real quick here. I'm not going to count this because I already counted it twice. And counting it four times does seem a bit excessive. And as long as that lines up on both sides, you should be good. Alright, now you can do that same thing with the quartz slabs and then the upside down quartz stairs facing inwards, like so. Now you can come back again, this time only 8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Again, in front of that sign. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And just this final one that I won't count. And that should be in front of that sign, in front of those signs on both sides. Now, one more time, we can just do that same pattern with the quartz slab and then the quartz upside down stair facing inwards, just like so. Now, what we're going to do is a little bit different, again, on both sides. So first, let's see here. Okay, so we've got, actually, no, it will be the same on both sides, I believe. So we can come back just one more with that same half slab, top slab pattern, just like so. And then now with our blocks, we can come back 7 white wool. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We can then come in with your half slabs just in there, and then fill in that gap with a top slab. Now you can take out your blocks once again and just place one more behind each of those. And then now with your smooth stone, you can place 4 behind this on either side. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we'll come back 2 blocks more with your white wool. And then fill in this gap, and that will be 1, and then come back 5 and also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then now you can just get out your smooth sandstone stair and acacia button. The smooth sandstone stair is a smooth stone stair in the texture pack. You can just use a similarly colored stair to match with this slab here. Anyways, just place one of those upside down, and that gives it kind of that characteristic E380 APU shape. And then on the left side only here, we're going to place an acacia button, which is a black button in the Aeroteam texture pack. You can use your blackstone buttons if you were on 1.16, I think it is. And that will, 1.16.4 should have blackstone buttons. I'm not too familiar with the Minecraft versions, but that should be it. So you can use your blackstone buttons if you're in a higher version. If you're slightly lower down in 1.14 or whatever, you can use just a stone button, and it'll be pretty much the exact same. It's a pretty small detail just on the side of the APU right there. Anyways, that is all for layer 7, so now we're going to go on to layer 8. Now for layer 8, we can come up to the nose once again, and we're first going to be starting with our purple slabs, so you just place, again, that same triangle shape right behind these blocks here. Now what we can do is get out our stairs and just place one of those, behind each of those slabs, and then blocks behind each of those. So now what we're going to do is, for the windows of the upper layer, I'm almost 100% sure that this is the first double-decker plane tutorial on the channel. So yeah, this will be the first time there are two window layers in a single tutorial, making innovations at the Aeroteam here. Yeah, so starting with that, first from these blocks, we can just place a slab behind each of these, and then from this block, place two slabs out to the side, like so, and you can do that on both sides. Now we can get out our white wool blocks and just place four coming back from the slab. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. All right. Now for our windows. Now the windows do all face forward like this, which means that it's pretty hard to place them, you know, like having to go, like if I had to go back, it would have to be like this. That would take way too long, especially on some of these longer ones. So instead what I'm going to do is I'm going to count back the number and then place a full block there, which is will be there, and then come forward again. If you don't get what I mean, that's fine. It'll probably make sense in a minute here. So for this first one, we're going to count back seven blocks. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Then on that eighth one, which should be this quartz block, you can place an upside down quartz stair facing backwards here. And then coming forwards from this, place your purple stairs, just like so. And there we go. And that's a little bit easier. We can do that on both sides as well, just like so. And there we go. Coming back again, we just have one block back from each of these quartz stairs. And then now we're going to count back 17 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. On this 18th one, again, quartz upside down stair facing backwards. And we can do that on both sides here. And then now you can come forward with your purple stairs yet again. So we don't have to count that this time because we already did. There we go. And one more time. Alright, coming back once again, we can place another two blocks behind these windows. And then now we're going to count back six blocks. One, two, three, four, five, six. And then on the seventh one, which should not be this quartz, don't be fooled by that, we're going to place just one piece of white wool on each side. And then we're going to come forward with our stairs again. One, two, three, four, four, five, six. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There we go. And then now coming back from these blocks here, we've got our upside down quartz stairs facing backwards. Another full block behind each of those. And then now for these final two windows here, we're just gonna come back two blocks and place our two upside down windows like so. And there we go. That will be all for the windows. Now just to finish out the final parts of the tail. From the stair right here, we can just come back with three half slabs on both sides. And then top slabs on the inside to fill that gap, just like so. Now it is going to differentiate a little bit on both sides here because of the interior. There's screw rest areas right here. Which me and mine did put quite a bit of effort into there. You can see them right there to get them looking correct. So there's a lot of vertical slabs, stuff like that, to make it so you can actually fit in there and look inside. But anyways, that is going to cause a little bit of differentiation between the two sides. So anyways, on this left side here, we can place a purple stair facing inwards that is upside down, like so. And on the right side, just a block. And then with both of these on the right side, we can come back six, including this one. So one, two, three, four, five, six. And on this side, just five. So one, two, three, four, and five. Coming back further, we can take our stairs again. Or sorry, not our stairs, our slabs. And come back three on both sides. Inside that gap, we can come back with our white wool and just go back six blocks. One, two, three, four, five, and six. And then just one slab at the end, I believe, is how that should end. Yep. And this layering does get a little bit weird here, just because that's the base of the tail. So in reality, it wouldn't actually look like that. It's just like it has to go this one, two, because the tail is right there. So yeah, don't worry, that will get fixed. But yeah, that is all for layer 8. Alright, now for the final layer of the A380 fuselage. Now this layer will be a little bit complicated because, as you can see, there are already a fair amount of airfoil extensions, domes, stuff like that on top of the fuselage. And that's all added to the fact that basically this entire top layer is upside down stairs to make more space for the upper layer interior. So this might get a little bit complicated, but don't worry, if I can record this, you can probably build it if I record it well enough. We'll see. This might take a couple cuts, but we'll see how it goes. So without further ado, we can come up just behind this first block right here and just come back one, and we can come back three blocks in all with our purple slabs and do that on both sides as well. Just set one back to follow that sort of triangle shape that we've been doing. All right, coming back again, in this gap we can place one white wool block, and now we're going to come back, let's see, 9 blocks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now what we can do is get out our purple stairs, place one facing backwards, and then right behind that, one facing forwards. Continuing back now, we can place 27 more blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, and 27. Coming back again, actually, we're going to leave it like there for now because this is where stuff gets really complicated because of the crew rest areas. So that we'll leave for a bit later on. Coming back now to up here, we are now going to place our many stairs that are on the side of this thing. So starting off just on this first free block here, just widen that on both sides like that so you get this very elongated cross. And then now we're going to get out our purple stairs, and placing them like this, we are going to go 36 blocks back. So, and that's left side only, the right side is different. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's see, 11, 12, 13, 14, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, and 36. And let's just count that out because that was pretty stressful, and also make sure that there's no cornered off ones, which there are not. Okay, let's just come back to the front here. And yep, 36. All right, I actually got that right. That was pretty surprising. Okay, now on to the other side here. So this, let's see. I guess we can do this in the same sort of fashion. This side is going to be 42 blocks long. Sorry for the messages coming up right now. I can't turn those off. Even with chat off, the Discord messages still come through. So sorry about that. But yeah, so on the right side now, we'll go back 42, same fashion with the stairs facing inwards like so. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, and 42. And that will finish that off. That was quite hard. But yeah, once you're done, you should have something like this. And this kind of just is for the overhead bins in the upper deck. Alright. Now coming to the back now. This is a bit of a complicated section, so bear with me. But we're going to take our white wool first and just place a single block of that right behind the stairs. Now what we're going to do is place some stairs. I'm just doing an example real quick here. Place stairs in this sort of pattern. So on the left side here, we've got two facing to the right and just one in. So without that, it'll look just like what we were doing before, but now we're just making this a dewy stair, so keep that in mind. So with this block in here, we're just gonna come back three more facing inwards like so. And then let's see, and well, yeah, we'll leave that like that for now. Now here, we're gonna place them in the same orientation like this and come back six. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Like so, and that will finish that off. Now we're just gonna come back three blocks on this side, so 1, 2, 3, and then make this a row of three across like that, so you have sort of an L pattern here. Okay, coming back from this block right here, we're gonna have 13, so this one included, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13, and that's just the very back of the tail right there, you can see. And just off to the side of these, we're just going to place three purple slabs, like so. Alright, that should finish off the main part of the fuselage. That wasn't quite as bad as I had thought it would be. But now, we're going to be going onto the airfoil extensions, domes, lights, all that sort of stuff on top of the fuselage. So we'll see how that goes. Anyways, coming up to this first block here, we can come with our jungle buttons and count back two blocks, 1, 2, and on the third one, we're going to place a jungle button parallel to the fuselage, so make sure it's in this orientation and not like this. Come back another 2, 1, 2, and on that third one, a lever flipped facing backwards. Come back another two blocks, 1, 2, and on that third one, place a birch trapdoor and just another one behind it to make that two long. And I believe this is for the Wi-Fi dome on the top of the aircraft. Now what we can do is get out our dark oak buttons, which in the Aeroteam texture pack are a red texture. And now what we would normally do is place a beacon light like that. However, the A380 is actually so tall that its beacon lights are like this. It actually has two beacon lights on the top of the aircraft, and that's so that if you look here, if we place one in the center and one on the side here, you can see the outer one like this much further in and closer to the ground than the inner one. So you can start seeing that here, and this might not be fully realistic, but it takes a lot longer for the, yeah, it's still not even coming, there it is, now it's finally in view. So when ground crews are working around the aircraft, the beacon lights are what indicate that the aircraft is on, especially that the engines are on, so it's very important for them to be able to see those beacon lights. They do have a beacon light on the bottom of the fuselage as well, right there. But for, you know, certain reasons, you might not be able to see that one. Or if you're air traffic control and looking to see if the aircraft's engine lights are on, or sorry, not engine lights, if its engines are on, having two beacon lights like this is very important. And to my knowledge, it's the only aircraft with two beacon lights on the top. I think even the 747 only has one. Anyways, coming back yet again here, from these trapdoors, we're going to come back six blocks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and on that seventh one, place a jungle button. Now coming back another four blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, on that fifth one, we're going to be placing a lever, flick facing backwards, of course you want it like that. And then coming back again, we're going to come back 11 blocks this time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and on that 12th one, we can just place another lever, flip facing backwards, and one more time, we can go back 8 blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, and on that 9th one, just your last lever, just like so. And that should be the entire A380 fuselage. So congratulations, you have completed the first part of the tutorial. Yeah, this is probably going to be a pretty long tutorial. I haven't even finished filming it yet, but I think it's been about an hour to an hour and a half so far, probably. I haven't really checked the length of video clips. But anyways, let's get on to the vertical stabilizer that is quite large. So, yeah. Alright, so now starting on the vertical stabilizer here, we'll first be starting at this block in the back here. And we could just come up one block from that with a purple top slab out to the side of that. come up two more blocks, and then out to the side again. Let's see here. We've got... Okay, two more blocks on top of that. Out to the side again. And then we're going to repeat that pattern. Let's see. Six times in all. So we've got one, two, three. Out to the side. Four, five, and six. And that should do it. Now, coming from the top of this very large vertical stabilizer, we're going to come four blocks forward, so one, two, three, four, and just one purple slab right there. Now we're going to come down with our stairs. However, this is going to take a while because I'm going to have to place like a block and then a stair like so. So instead, we're going to start down here, and then we can make our way back up. So with your birch trapdoor, just behind this lever, place two birch trapdoors, and then a purple slab, a white waffle block, and then your first purple stair, and we can just keep making our way up like that. Let's see here. This is gonna take a while here. What's there? And just like that. Pretty simple. Now all we have to do is fill in the inside. Not much to say while doing this, so I will not take too much during this. And there we go. Now, if you look over there, you can see some buttons on the back of the top of the tail, and those are static wicks. Basically, when the plane flies through any sort of storm, sometimes electricity can accumulate in the aircraft, as well as water that's charged with electricity, which would not be good if it, like, you know, zapped the aircraft. I don't know too much about it, but basically what these are for is it attracts the water to them so they stream off without, like, accidentally damaging the plane in any way. So yeah, they're called static wicks because they discharge the static from the aircraft. Now this is on this example aircraft over here. However, I can't, when me and mine were redoing this thing, I don't remember him ever mentioning that there actually weren't any, because I've been looking at some pictures, and in all the real life pictures I've seen, there are no static wicks on the top of the vertical stabilizer. So currently, I'm just going to leave it like that. I did ask him in the Discord, he has not responded yet, but if he does respond and say, like, yeah, that's a thing that's on some of them, I will show you guys how to add them. However, as it stands currently, I can't find any pictures with them on there, so we'll just leave them like that. Now we will go on to the horizontal stabilizers. Alright, so now for the horizontal stabilizer, we're first going to be starting with our smooth stone slabs, and we're just going to place a nice top slab right here on the second block of this smooth stone right here, and just place a jungle trapdoor on top of that. Now with your stone brick slabs, go back three full blocks, one, two, three, then you can place one smooth stone full block, get out your smooth stone stairs, and place a backwards facing upside down one like so, and then come in one and just place two smooth stone top slabs. So overall, you should have a route that looks like this. Okay, moving out. We're first going to just be doing the basic outline here. So coming out from this first stone brick block here, just place one top slab out diagonally for one more top slab, and out diagonally again, extend this into a row of two, and then go out diagonally and up a half slab. Out diagonally four times, so three times. So one, two, three, and that should leave you with a row of four, and just make this fourth one into a row of two. Out and up diagonally again, and then come back diagonally, do that one more time, and that should give you a row of three. Make this one in a row of two, but do it the opposite way than we've been doing them, to sharpen this back. And then come back diagonally and make that another row of two. Now coming in, just make this into an L shape, like so. Come in and make a row of two. Come in again and make a row of two. Come down and in. Like so. And a row of three. One, two, three. Come in for a row of two again. And then down and in one more time for a row of two. And then just connect that up with the beginning for another row of two. And that should be the basic outline of the wing. I'll give you a top view just like this to help you if you missed that. And just a view like this, you can see where it rises and lowers. And maybe a wing, a row of the a view of the root as well. All right. Hopefully you figure that all out by now. So now we'll be moving on to the layers. So getting out your stone brick slabs here. I'm going to come to this first smooth stone slab that's still there up, and just come out with your stone brick slabs. Come out again diagonally with one more stone brick slab. Make that into a row of two with a smooth stone slab, and then come out again for another row of two, like so. And now for the last layering outline, I just come out diagonally from here and just for a row of two, just like so. Very easy. And now, finally, before you just get to fill in the whole thing, we're just going to finish out this stone brick sort of walk area that is on the top of the wing. So we're just going to place a row of three, like so, and then another one back from that again. And then we're going to have a row of two, like so. And then, let's see here, another row of two to make it a full row of three with that one that's a layer up. Then we can extend this one out two for another row of three. One more row of three out, and then just another row of two. Sorry if that was a little bit confusing. There's another view with that, and a view with the layers. And now, if you followed our tutorials before, you probably know what to do next, and that is to just fill everything in with smooth stone slabs. So, here we go. This wing, luckily, is not too big, so that will only take a couple seconds, and there we go. Now, for one final detail, we will be putting the static wicks on the end of the stabilizer right here. So, to do that, let me just see my reference real quick. Alright, so we're going to first just place three temporary blocks just in these areas right there. Now you're going to get your stone button, and let's see, real quick. Okay, so I'm going to come out a couple blocks just for a temporary block, make this into a full block, and then just place a stone button parallel with the aircraft, just like so. Now you're going to get your stick, type slash REPL 0, like so, and I'll just say block replace your tool bound to stick. Just left-click on this button, and then right-click over on these three slabs. And that'll give you your three static wicks that are at the end. Oh, actually, sorry. There's actually five of them. I must have accidentally not copied them, so you can just replace them over two more times. Just there should be five buttons on the end of the horizontal stabilizer in all. And that will be it for the horizontal stabilizer. So now we're going to move on to the wing, which is going to be scary. At least for me. I don't know about you guys, but we'll see how well I can record this so to make it as easy as possible. Anyways, moving on. Alright, now to start the wing. This is going to be a big one, so I'm going to be recording this in segments, so first, I'm just going to try and get the root and the outline done, then we'll do the layers, and then finally come in at the end, because it's just so big. And it's the biggest one I've ever done, so we'll see how this goes. So anyways, you might notice how there's like this sort of fuselage section that sort of comes out like this. Looks kind of weird. So this is actually the back end of the wing box. On some of the newer Airbus wide bodies, there's the back section of the wing box that like, comes out more, so that's on the A380, A350, the A350s is actually even weirder. I think maybe the A330, I'm not sure about that though. And yeah, so it's kind of just a weird thing that only happens on basically just Airbus aircraft. So yeah, I'll be showing you how to get around that. So anyways, starting at the wing root, we're first going to come down to this little area here at the bottom of this little wing root flange. And just get your smooth stone slab out and make this a 7 long rows. Or sorry, not 7, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now we're going to come up a half step and make that a row of 2. And then a full block here. It's split in between layers, so not technically really a full block, but it's the same dimensions. Now you're going to get your nether brick slab, which is a black slab in the Aeroteam texture pack. You can just use like some sort of black stone in default. And come back and up half slab, like so. Now with your stone brick slab, you're going to come back a 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Oh, now that's this first part of the wing. And now on top of this, we're also going to be building some stuff. So we're going to, on top of this, still on the same layer, just place 3 more, so like so. Come down a half slab, and one more nether brick slab. 3 more smooth stone slabs behind that, 1, 2, 3, and then just 2 more like so, just like that. Now for the bottom of the wing, if we come back to where we originally started, we can come up a half slab and just place a row of 3, 1, 2, 3, and then just come up one more, just like so. And that is the wing root. It does look a little bit weird just because of this little area, but yeah. So now we're going to start on the wing outline here. I'm just looking at my notes real quick. Okay, so starting at the root of the wing, we'll just be doing the outline. I'm just going to also get a torch. And these are the only things that you'll need. Blue concrete is just what I use, but you can use any sort of block that kind of stands out from the rest. That's just for a temporary block. Alright, so what we're first going to do is come back with another one of these, like, split in between full blocks, like so. And then on top of that, just come back diagonally with your nether brick slab. And same thing on the bottom with the smooth stone slab. Same thing again with the block. And then what we're going to have is a slab right here. Again, come out with that one and have that be a full block there. Right here, behind this, we can have another slab like so. Sorry if this is a bit confusing, I'll be pausing a lot to give you some angles that if it is a bit confusing, you can just keep looking back. And let's see here. So after this, we're going to be coming up a half slab again behind this. And coming out another one. Go 2 down with this, so it's a 1.5 tall little section, and then out of the middle of that, just get another smooth stone slab. From this block right here, we can come down with a slab like so, and that'll be basically it, I believe, for the sort of like double areas where you've got like stuff like this going on. Just the wing root is so thick that it's hard to get it in without doing some of that. I was the same way on the 777X tutorial. I reviewed it just to make sure I was recording this in like the most efficient way possible. So anyway, we can come back again just behind this single slab here and come out from that with a full block. And then behind this, just make this a row of 1.5, so it sticks at the bottom as well. And that will be the last of the sort of like double thick areas. So, without any more talking, we can get into the bulk of the wing area here. So coming back diagonally, we've just got another block like so, and then out diagonally again, just a single top slab on the, or I guess technically it would be a half slab, on the top part of this block that was before it. Out diagonally again with a full block like so, and then, let's see here. Now we can come back diagonally again with another block, and this is where you're going to take your blue concrete or whatever you want to use, and just place a block there. It's for the first engine pylon. Now we can just come out again with your smooth stone slab, just for one half slab, come out diagonally again like so, and let me just switch to another picture here so I can see it a little bit better. Alright, okay, so now we're going to have, let's see, 4 diagonals in a row, so starting from here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, And let's see, on go back one more, and on the fifth one here, we're gonna have one more row of two. Come back one more diagonally, like so, and then come out diagonally and up. Now we're gonna come back two diagonally, one and two, and let me just check if this is correct here. Yep, okay, so come back diagonally again, and make that a row of two. And on this first block in the row of two, we can displace another blue concrete for the second engine pylon. Now what we're gonna do is have another row of four diagonals. So one, two, three, four. And then come back diagonally again one more and make that a row of two. Now we're gonna have another row of two. And just at the end of that, we can get out our polished granite slab. And just diagonally again with that. That's a red slab in the Aeroteam texture pack, and that's used for the navigation light at the end of the wing. Now this is a red slab in the Aeroteam texture pack, however there is no like pure red slab in default. The closest I would say would be brick or maybe copper, if you're in one of those newer versions. But yeah, so anyways, moving on. We can now come back diagonally again with the smooth stone slabs once more and make this a row of four. One, two, three, and four. Now, on our way in, let's see here. Don't have any good views of that. Okay, so this first layer here is just gonna be a row of two. I'm gonna come in diagonally again with another row of two. Again with another row of two, and in all there should be, let's see, one, two, three, four, five rows of two. So one, two, three, four, and five. Come in diagonally. And then now what we're gonna do is come diagonally once more, and come down a half slab. Make this a row of three in all, so one, two, three, and then come in one, two. Come in again with just a single block, down a half slab, come in diagonally again, make that a row of two, one more row of two there, come in diagonally just for one, diagonally just for one again, and then down a half slab and make that a row of two, above it'll be a row of three, and then down a half slab again, like so, so it's actually a row of four. And then in, like so, for a row of two, and again for a row of one, and down one more half slab, just to complete that off with a row of three. And yeah, that will be the final wing outline. There's an above, view, just to, in case you missed anything. And there's just one where you can see more of the actual layers. One for the wing root as well, because I know that area is very complicated. One above, one below, like so. And yeah, just you can pause at any point just to take a look. But yeah, that's going to be the first clip for the wing, so we'll just cut to the next one where I'll be working on the layers. Okay, moving on with the wing. You might notice these blue blocks on the black on the back that were not here before. These are for the flap track fairing markings. I forgot to put them in at the beginning of the, or in the wing outline section. So I just put them in right before here. And if I fly up right now, you should be able to screenshot it or just pause the video. Take a screenshot and then just copy those onto your plane. Those are just temporary blocks for the location of the flap track fairings. Moving on with the top of the wing layering, I'm first going to come down to the back of the trailing edge here, or the closest inwards area of the trailing edge, and just place one smooth stone slab like so. Pretty simple layer. Next up, coming up to this stone brick slab here, we're going to come out three stone brick slabs, and then out diagonally one. Let's see. Oh, actually, sorry. That's not what we're going to do. So you got the three here already. Come out diagonally one, nether brick slab behind that, nether brick slab out diagonally one. Let's see. And then a smooth stone slab right behind that. And then come back diagonally until you hit the trailing edge. Next up, we're going to come up to right here, actually. And you can get out your nether brick slab for that. Come out diagonally, just like so. Come back three stone, stone brick. And then out diagonally three blocks again. Out diagonally two more. And then diagonally one with a nether brick slab behind that. Out diagonally one with a nether brick slab. And then, let's see, just bring that back to here with your stone brick or smooth stone slabs. Coming up to here, we can come out directly with your nether brick slabs. You should have those three blocks in a line. And then we're going to place four stone brick slabs in a row. Come back to only two. And then another two. And then with your nether brick slab, come back diagonally in sections of one twice. And then your smooth stone slab out and just bring that all the way back. And for the final layer at the top of the wing, we're going to again come out directly like so. Place three stone brick slabs out diagonally, and then coming in, you have two stone brick slabs, another brick slab, and another nether brick slab, and then just bring your stone slabs back diagonally for one more. And that'll be all of the layering for the top of the wing. Luckily, not too bad. The A380 has kind of a flat wing. You can see it kind of curves up and really flattens out at the ending section, so not too bad. Before we fill all this in, though, we are going to just outline the rest of these areas. As you can see, there's some interesting markings on here that are not fully done, and that's what they should look like when they are done. Okay, so starting at the root of the wing here, first off, just in this little area here, place one nether brick slab, and then coming up again, just so I can see, in between here, just another one like so. So you should have these four in a row here. Let's see. You can take this one and just bring it back into this stone brick slab. I'm trying not to get lost here. And then out diagonally to connect it with this one. Coming. Let's see. And then what we're going to have is. Actually, I'm going to come to the end of the wing here. From this. Red slab right here. We're going to make a little L shape like so. And then we're going to come in, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sections of two, two block long nether brick slabs. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then that comes up with that. And then on the sixth one, that should be split between the layers like so. Coming in from that, we'll just have a single one, and then come in again and restart the two block long layers. Just bring that out once more, and then connect that with this one, and that should give you something that looks like this. Now for the front of the wing, not too complicated again. Basically, what we're doing is just following the outline of the wing just one block behind. So, starting all the way at the tip here, we can just place blocks all the way along this, like so, and up until right here, I believe, where instead of, or actually, a little bit before that, what we're going to do instead is you can have this block here, and then inside of here, we're just gonna have a row of three coming back, like so. So you've got 1, 3, and then this section of two, and then you can make this three long. That's really like a little cutout at the beginning of the wing there in that black section. Now, to finish off the top of the wing, inside of these black areas, you're gonna want to fill that with stone brick slab, and outside you're going to fill that with your smooth stone slab. So you followed our tutorials before, you probably know just about what to do, but basically all you're going to do is fill in these holes right here. So starting up here, you can just fill this area in like so, and let's see, not a lot to talk about during this time, so sorry if I'm a little bit quiet here. Or just a question of like not missing any blocks or accidentally messing up the layering. There we go. If you want a little trivia about this, most people watching probably know this already, but this little black outline area is actually the area where you're allowed to walk on the wing. So, for instance, like in the center of the wing where it's strong enough to, at least I think that's what it is, I'm pretty sure that's what it is, but like you're not allowed to walk like on the flaps, but if you're doing like aviation maintenance, it's like a easy way to see like where you're allowed and not allowed to walk, because that could damage the flaps or slats on the front, depending on if you accidentally get too close. Alright, coming along pretty well here. Just gotta fill in this area. Almost done here. Just a little bit more of the smooth stone slabs. And that should be it. Oh, a little bit more. And there we go. So that is the entirety of the top of the wing. There's just a little bit of an overhead view in case you missed anything. You can just copy that real quick. And because you can't really see the layers in that, if you view from like here where you can see the layering a little bit more easily. And one of the front over here. Alright. So now we're going to move on with the bottom of the wing layering. Alright, continuing on with the wings, we're now going to work on the bottom layering, and as well as just the entire bottom face of the wing. So before we get started here, I just do want to mention that without the engine pylons, flap track fairing, all the extra details on the bottom, it might look a little bit weird, but don't worry about that, it'll all get sorted out by the end of this tutorial. So coming out to this final wing layer here, I suppose, we're going to be starting at the last one here, not at the wing root. Just come to this slab right here, but right before it changes the block height of the wing, and just come one slab back with your smooth stone slab, just extending back on this. Come out diagonally, and then do that once more, and then a stone brick slab on the end. Out diagonally, and two more stone brick slabs like so to make a row of three. Out diagonally again with one more stone brick, and then just a smooth stone slab right there. And that will be the first layer there. Coming to the second one here, we've got just right behind this temporary block here for the engine pylon. We've just got one smooth stone slab, one nether brick slab, and then one stone brick slab. Coming out diagonally, three stone brick slabs. Out diagonally again, and three more. And then a nether brick slab. Oh, I forgot to delete that. That's what it should look like beforehand. Just place another netherbrick slab on there, and then a smooth stone slab just to connect all this up. And again, that might look a little bit weird at the end, but don't worry, that'll all get fixed. Coming to our next one right here, we've got... Sorry, just looking here right here. Alright, we've got a... Coming back from that, we have a row of five smooth stone slabs, including this one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we're just going to come out diagonally and then just bring it all the way back. Just like so, and that should land right there. Next one here, we have a row of six coming back from here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And again, we're just going to come out diagonally and then bring that all the way back right here. Again, right here, we've got... this one right here, let me see real quick. Let's see where that'd be. Oh yes, yeah, so for this one we're gonna actually, it gets a little bit weird here. It's not on my notes for some reason, but we'll just come down diagonally like so, from this row right here, just to one back. And then I believe it's gonna be like so, just right there. So I'm going to splice that in right now, because it does look a little bit weird without it. Okay, so continuing back from here, we have a row of six blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then, let's see, coming in a row of three, and then in again, and just finish that off right there. Coming back to the front here, let's see here. We've got, ooh, this is confusing. Okay, so coming up to here, we've got extending this just two blocks right like so, and then come out diagonally like there, and then that's going to be coming back. I believe that is eight blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and yeah, you should be left with just two right there. Okay, and then just to fill this in, I've got, so we're gonna fill in the bottom of the wing now. The pattern is going to be a little bit weird, but that will all get sorted out. So don't worry about that. Let's see. Okay, so coming all the way out here, just as a small detail, if you get out your stone buttons, and just at the back of the wing right here, on this second to last row of two nether brick slabs here, just place two stone buttons, like so. I believe those are small details under the aileron. Coming to the first empty layer here, at this point we can just fill it in with the pattern above it, so not to worry too much about that right now. So yeah, you can just do that real quick. Coming to the second one, however, things are going to get a little bit more complicated. So starting all the way at the back here, we do have, let's see here, that would be, okay, so this would be right, there, I believe, and then we have, yes, okay, so, this gets very convoluted on the bottom of the wing, sorry about this, yes, okay, I was looking at the wrong area. Okay, so coming up to the front of the wing right here, we're gonna have two nether brick slabs, just like so. And then you can bring this stone brick back two blocks. And then that should just intersect with these smooth stone slabs here. Bring back these stone bricks slabs all the way. And yeah, I think it's the same for all in here, so you can just fill it in with the same pattern as above. And yep, that will be that. So from now on in here, it's just going to be smooth stone. No need to copy the pattern because there's enough space in between that we don't have to do that. So it should be a little bit easier. Just like so. This one is, again, just smooth stone right here. Yes, that area does get a little bit interesting. So right here, if you're trying to place a block right there or there, that doesn't work. So just for these two blocks here, we're just going to have one nether brick slab and one stone brick slab there, because that cannot be covered by just smooth stone there. Right here, we just got, again, two smooth stones covering in just these final few layers here. And then this little hole here, I believe, let's see here. Yes, so this hole, it should just be a singular block hole. Instead of using smooth stone there, we're just going to place a single block of cobblestone, like that. And then just for this final layer here, we just fill this in. And for one final detail on the bottom of the wing, you're going to want to get your stone buttons out again. And counting on this last layer here, just from this last block, come up one. And place a stone button right here on the second layer. Skip a block and place another one right there. It's kind of a weird placement, but that is where they are. So that is where they are in the build too. Alright, and that will do it for the main part of the wing. I think that is everything. Alright, continuing on with the flap track fairings. If you don't know what those are the little pods at the end of the wing there. They contain the flap tracks, which are important for the flaps deployment, especially on a large aircraft like this. So starting all the way out at the outboard one, or outboardmost one, we are first just in between these two temporary blocks here. It's going to create a line of 9 blocks of smoothstone, like that. And you can now delete those temporary blocks. Now up in the front, it might look a little bit weird. That's just because for this outermost one, it actually connects to the engine pylon. So we're just going to end it at that last smoothstone block and then continue back with it, with the entire engine and the rest of the pylon when we get to the engines. So we just got that row of 9 blocks. At the very end here, we can do a polished granite slab here. And then we're going to take a activator rail and just place one down and just keep placing them around, there we go, until it pops into this upper one so that it is, if you place a block next to it, it's on the upper half. Get your stick, type slash REPL 0, and just left click it. You're not, if you're new to the Aeroteam pack and you might not know this, this is based on a rail, so the hitbox is still down here, even though the actual rail, or the trapdoor itself is up here. So you're gonna have to click down there, place a temporary block under that red slab, and just paste that over. If you're not in the texture pack, or you don't have rolled edit, actually you can do this if you don't have rolled edit. If you just place a barrier block under here, and then place a rail on top of that. If you do not have the pack, you can just use like an acacia slab, or an acacia trapdoor might work. So yeah, continuing on, just forward of this, we're just going to place 3 smoothstone trapdoors, which are the jungle trapdoor. And that's it for that first one there. So moving in one, we're just going to remove this temporary block right here and get in its place, it's not working for some reason, in its place, create a full block of smoothstone in between two layers, so it should be a half slab. Oh, there it goes. The server was being laggy for some reason. Yeah, so that's what you should have in the, like, in between the layers there. Just back at that, polished granite slab, but this time with an activator rail on top of it, and that's going to be the one where you want the lower one. Again, a case trapdoor in default. Forward of this, we can place 2 more of these full blocks, or like in between layer full blocks of smoothstone, so just like so. And then when we get here, you're not going to be able to place one, so get out your nether brick slab and just place another brick slab there. Forward of that, you can just place, oh, and yeah, we're not going to be able to do that there either. Forgot about that one. Oh yes, actually, we are able to, because this area does not need to be, smoothstone, or, stone brick slabs on the bottom. However, this does, as you can see, it's only a slab thick. So that does need to be, but yeah, the rest of this can, in fact, be, just smoothstone all the way up. So 2 more full blocks forward of that black slab, and then just 3 more slabs just in front right there. And that'll do it for that second one. Actually, no, it won't. On the very back, you're just going to get out an end rod and place that right in the back. I believe that is for the fuel dumping like little probe that they dump the fuel out of, so you know the fuel has a, there are wing tanks, so the wing tanks probably come up to about there, and inside, you know, if they need to do an emergency landing or something and they're landing, they're, the aircraft is too heavy, the easiest way to get rid of fuel quickly is to dump it instead of just burning it. So they just open up this little tube here, and the fuel can flow out. I'm not fully sure that's what it is. It might be just another static wick, like we've seen. Actually, I haven't put on it on this aircraft, but like the little on the back of the tail layer, like those that just disperse lightning. But I'm pretty sure it is the fuel dumping probe. So yeah, moving in again to this third one here. Let's see here. Got, so coming back from this block here, you can just delete that and place a jungle trapdoor where it was with a full block of smoothstone under it, and then a full block of polished granite right there. Place 4 more Four more, or sorry, not four more, three more smooth stone full blocks to make a total of four here. So one, two, three, four, and then two smooth stone slabs there. And then this is kind of an interesting one. In front of that, we just have a single stonebrick slab right there. This is again like in between there, so we gotta just do this over that upper section there, like so. Moving in again, we've got our one here, and that one will be, if you just delete this block here, a full block of your whatever red block you're using, and then we get to roll that on another one of the top activated rails to go on the bottom of it, just like so. And then moving in from that, we've got five smooth stone blocks, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then three jungle trapdoors, like so, and then just in front of that block, a singular smooth stone slab right there. And finally, just this one right here, we have, let's see here, gotta get a different view, okay, we've got a full block of polished granite, right there, with a activator rail above it, like so, and then six full blocks of smooth stone in front of it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, with a smooth sandstone stair, and then a smooth sandstone slab right in front of that. I believe it's 6, let me just count that again. Oh sorry, actually it's 5, so just delete that first one up there, and then just replace those two stairs and slabs. And then just on the bottom, we've just got four jungle trapdoors there, smooth stone trapdoors. And that will do it for the wing fairings. So now what we're going to do is we got to do the winglet real quick. So yeah, not drills, or wing is not quite done yet, but we're getting close. Okay, so now just to finish up with the wing with some final details. We just have the winglet, a couple static wicks, and then I want to add the static wicks onto the tail because I did forget to do that. And then we can start on the engines. So, coming out to the very tip of the wing, on this third block back right here, we're just going to place a single purple slab there with a full block right behind it and a dead brain coral fan off of that. Now the dead brain coral fan is a vertical slab. I might have mentioned it before in this tutorial. I can't really remember. But yeah, it's a white wool white wool vertical slab in the pack. You might not have the pack, so in that case you can just use a wall here. I think a diary wall might work. But yeah, not a lot of options to get around that. So yeah, I do highly suggest using the pack for this if you can get it. And then just on top of this, just a singular, another purple slab. Coming off of this block on the bottom here, just another block below that, and a birch trapdoor just north of that. And that's it for the winglet. Very simple, pretty small on 1-to-1 scale, pretty small on 1.5 to 1 scale even. So yeah, and now just for some final details. If you don't have rolled it, well, I guess, yeah, you can do some of these if you don't have rolled it, just with barrier blocks and stuff like that. So, to start here, what we're just going to do is I'm going to just place a button down here and just select it with my stick so that I just have that in my, I don't even know, like clipboard, I guess you could call it. And then I can just paste that around without having to like reselect it every time. Now I'm just going to get a temporary block here and just place those all over the plane. And I can just come back and, I'll replace that with a button after I'm done. So first one is going to be right behind this bottom block here, and another one just behind the slab, and that's the two on the winglet. Now on these first six blocks here, these first three pairs of two here, you just place one behind each of those. And then on the top of the tail here, we're just going to be placing them on the first five blocks here, I think. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, just like so. And yeah, so now we can just go around, and I think that's actually going to be a different one, so we'll come back to that in a second. But yeah, for all these other ones on the wing, we can just right click over, just like so. Now those are all the static clicks on the back of the wing. Now for up here, it's going to be the top one, like so, not placed on a block, but based on the bottom side. So we can just select that and paste that over as well. Just like so. You might not be able to do that one if you have rolled it. So yeah, you might want to use like levers on the back or something like that, or maybe just end rods. It's up to you. So yeah. But yeah, that is basically it for the wing. Now all we gotta do is flip it, and then there is one more detail, a couple more. So right before we flip it here, I'm just gonna get my torch out. If you don't have folded it, again, you can ignore this detail. But for the landing lights here, on this third slab out, the top one, just place a temporary block there, torch in front of that, and just replace that over and delete that one, just like so, for the landing lights. But yeah, now we can flip the wing real quick. So we're just going to come up to this root block here, /1. A lot of people do like /pause1, but I discovered that you actually only need to do one. You don't need to do the pause. So anyways, /2 right there. And now, standing in the center line of the plane, doesn't really matter what height or anything. I can even do it all the way from up here. /copy, /flip, I think it's west, and paste -A so that it doesn't paste the air, just the blocks. And there we go. A perfectly flipped wing. Now, if you don't have rolled it, you can just, you know, build this wing again. Shouldn't be super hard. You've already got one under your belt, so you could probably do that same one a little bit faster and more easily. Alright, and just for one final detail of the wing, so you might not know this, but the A380 actually has asymmetrical, or at least one asymmetrical flap track fairing. It's this inner one, and on this side, the side that we built together, it's longer. As you can see, it's a fairly big one. However, on the other side, it's a little bit shorter. I'm not exactly sure why that is. I can't really think of anything. So if you know the answer, maybe put it in the comments so that other people can learn from that. But I haven't been able to find anything on the internet or anything. So yeah, anyways, now that we have flipped our wing, we can just change that real quick. So all of the changes that we're going to be needing to make are just delete this first trapdoor to leave only three. And then this slab, stair, and that first block. And then now you can just replace, just right in front of this block right here, just place one more swiftstone slab. And that's it. And that's just the slightly shorter version on the right side wing. So yeah, that is the wings of the A380. Pretty big, very hard. Sorry if a couple sections of it was confusing. But yeah, now we can move on to the engines. And there's either the, I believe those are the Engine Alliance 7200s, or EA 7200s, I believe. And then the Trent 700s back there, the Rolls-Royce Trent 700s, or actually Trent 900s, not 700s. I think that's the one. I might have been getting them flipped back, so that might be wrong. But yeah, you can see how to build both of those, and yeah. Alright, so, starting on the engines now, we're first going to be building just the pylons for the engines, because those stay the same between the Trent 900s right there, and the Engine Alliance GP7200s, I believe they're called. So the pylons are the exact same, it's just and most of the cowling is too, it's mainly just the detailing. But yeah, so we'll just be starting right here at this first temporary block. You can just break that, and with your cobblestone, just replace that with a cobblestone block, and come out one block further with that. Next, with your smooth stone slab, come out two blocks further, and then underneath these cobblestone blocks, just place two more blocks, and extend that one more back for a row of three in total. Now coming back with your smooth stone blocks, you're going to just place a row of four, one, two, three, four, then a smooth stone stair, upside down facing backwards, and then two smooth stone slabs, just like so. And now just the final thing right here, we place in the center of these two, or in this row of four smooth stone blocks, In the center too, displace cobblestone slabs. And then get out your stripped spruce wood in the Aeroteam pack. This is both a half spruce, half black texture, as well as a half cobblestone, half black texture. And which one you're gonna want? The one that is the cobblestone on top and black wool on the bottom. So just kind of place it on different sides of the blocks. Like that's two of them right there. So you want this one right here. So yeah, and that should be all for the inner engine pylon. Now we're going to be moving on to the outer engine pylon. Now this one, as you can see here, we already deleted the temporary block for it because this flap track fairing just continues, it kind of merges into the engine pylon. So starting at this first smooth stone block here, we're just going to get three full blocks of cobblestone and just extend that out. On top of that, we are going to place a smooth stone slab on top of this smooth stone block right here, and then one more in front of that, a spruce trapdoor, which is a stone texture in the Aeroteam texture pack, on top of that middle cobblestone. And then let's see here, that's not what we're going to be doing. We're going to place a cobblestone slab there, a spruce trapdoor in front of that, and then two jungle trapdoors in front of that. So you should have that in all. And just to finish it off real quick, we've got our half cobblestone, half black block again right there on that first, or just under that first smooth stone block. And then two more cobblestone slabs behind that. And that is just the engine pylons. I'm also going to be doing this on the other side because I will not be mirroring the engines. And the reason for that is there's some details in the engines that do not get mirrored, some that do, so it'll just be safer if I just build each of the four engines individually rather than just building one or like one side and then mirroring them and then having to fix it. So moving on to the other side here, we can come to this temporary block and just delete that, get your cobblestone out, and just place those two blocks there with the two smooth stone slabs in front of that. Two cobblestone blocks below the two that you already placed, plus one right behind that. And then we're gonna have our four smooth stone blocks right here. Smooth stone upside, or smooth, sandstone stair upside down facing backwards, and then two smooth stone top slabs. Coming back up to the front here, we've got our stripped spruce wood, once again, cobblestone on top, nether brick slab on the bottom, and then two smoothstone slabs right by, or sorry, not smoothstone, two cobblestone slabs right there. And that's the second inner engine pylon. And now just for the outer one, if we just come out here, delete this block, and then we've got our cobblestone here, and just make that a row of three blocks. On top of this first one, we've got a smooth stone slab. On top of the second one, a cobblestone slab. And on top of the last one, a spruce trapdoor. And then just extend that out with two more jungle trapdoors. And then coming under these three smooth stones right here, we've got our stripped spruce wood once again. And then our two cobblestone top slabs. And that will do it for all of the engine pylons. So now we'll be moving on to the Trent 900s, and then finally the Engine Alliance 7200s. Alright, so starting with the Trent 900s here. We're first going to be starting on the inner engine, and then we'll be moving on to the outer engine. So, we're first going to come up to these two first slabs right here, and just place a row of three white wool blocks right there. And then we are going to build the outline of the front of the nacelle. So get out your smooth stone and just place one block in front of that and one block inwards from that to create a row of two across. And come down diagonally and make a 4x4 circle, just like so. And then now with your jungle trapdoors, just place those across the top half and close those up. And that just creates the very slight angle forward that the front of the nacelle has. A lot of aircraft have this, and I'm not actually sure why. It's very interesting, though. And yeah, we've represented that pretty well here with just some simple trapdoors. So anyways, moving on. We now are going to work on the other side of the top of the engine. Let me just get the other side picture here. Okay, so We can place our three blocks right here, and then just a proper stair right there, and well, that's how we'll leave that for now. Now I'm just going to work on the inside of the engine real quick, because that'll be pretty hard to do once we get the entire nacelle in. So actually what we're first going to do real quick is just place a row of blocks right around there, and on these outer sides just place slabs above and below, like so. That'll just help us place the fan blade. So the fan blade, we've got a nice design for it, and the way that you can do that is, let me just see here, I don't actually have any pictures of it. Okay, so let's see if I can do this from memory. So you're first in the bottom right hand corner, going to place a upside down blackstone, polished blackstone stair facing inwards like so. Then a, that's pretty hard to place, there we go, a right side up stair also facing inwards. On top of that, I believe it's, no, that's not right. Oh, sorry, like so. So just a regular stair facing outwards, and then to finish it off, an upside down stair facing outwards, like so. Now, moving on from that, we can just move back, and with our stone brick slabs, just create a row in the middle, like so. Then a circle of stone brick stairs just behind that, and then just another row of stone brick slabs. Coming off of that, we're now going to get out our diorite stairs and just place another circle of that and just another one right behind that. And then you can get out your acacia trapdoor and, let's see, your nether brick slab here. The acacia trapdoor is a black trapdoor in the Aeroteam texture pack. I'm not sure if default has a black one, so if not, just leave this off, but if you do, you can do this. So from looking forward from behind the engine, this half black, half cobblestone block, just on the other side of the engine, place your nether brick slab like so, and then place your acacia trapdoors above and below those like that. And that just gives a nice, like sort of cone shape to it, where you can't really get a cone because it's four blocks wide, so we can't really narrow it down too much, but that gives a pretty good representation of what we're trying to do there. Anyways, moving on, I actually just remembered, instead of placing a white wool here, we're instead going to delete that and get out your coal ore and just place one of those there. And that's for a small like vent on the bottom of the engine. And that's always, like, even on the other side, it's still, or the other side of the aircraft, it's still on this side. So that's one of the details that does not get flipped. So just be careful of that. Moving backwards now, you can get out your white wool as well as, let's see here, your iron trapdoor and birch trapdoor. And we're first, I'm just going to delete a couple blocks of the ground so I can get under the engine here. Just place an iron trapdoor under that coal ore, and then a birch trapdoor under that white wool on the other side. Moving back from that, we can just place another row of white trapdoors across. Let's see here. Okay, so now what we're going to do is just continue the bottom here. So just place two white wool blocks above that, extend that one further back, and then get out your purple stairs and place those upside down like so. Then just your purple top slabs and place another row. Moving to the side of the engine now, we've got, get out your white wool again and just place, let's see, it should be in all five rows, but we've got one already, so 2, 3, 4, and 5, like so. And then you can extend these purple slabs so that they're three long in total, just like so. And there you go. Now we can do that on the other side real quick. So extending this to a row of five, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then just extend these out too. So I'm just gonna cover this up quick again. Just like so. And that's the base of the engine. Now, really quick, we're just going to put on some more details. So get out your acacia button, stone button, and jungle signs. So on the outside of the engine, on the outside side of it facing outwards, get out your acacia button, and on your second wool block back, just place one there, and then a stone button directly behind that. And then on the inside, this is going to be a little bit hard because the wing does come a bit close here. On the second block back, we're going to place another acacia button and then a jungle sign above that. And that's just for a little wing kind of thing that comes off the inside of the engine for some aerodynamic purpose. All right, and that should be the inner engine complete. Oh, actually, there is one more detail that we can put on the engine pylon that I forgot about originally. So on the inner one, we're just going to get out your stone button out, and just on this first cobblestone block, place a stone button right there. And that'll do it for the inside engine on the left side. Now for the outer engine, just got to replace my materials again real quick. Just like so. I guess I'll have to stay up there for a second. Okay, so moving on to the outer engine. We can again forward from these cobblestone blocks right here, place three white walls, and then a block of smoothstone in front of that. One out to the left, like so, and then again just create that circle, just like so. Get your jungle trapdoors again, and place those on the upper half of the block to get that nice slight angle there. On the inside top, just place a row of three white wool, then a purple stair, and a purple slab, like so. I believe so it should be. Yep, that looks right. And then for the bottom, again, we can get out our, let's see, coal ore and iron trapdoor. Coal ore on the outside, white wool on the inside, and then create that, I think white wool, yeah, white wool will go back one further like so to create a three block long, a little space in total, purple stairs and then purple slabs. And then with your trapdoors, just place them the same as before, like, just like so. Now for the inside of the engine, again, we can get out those black stones there, just like I accidentally got rid of, so we can do that again. Just gotta check the pattern again real quick. Okay, so get your upside down one facing inwards there, regular one facing inwards there, and then that's not gonna be a possible place, so I gotta place a temporary block there. Upside down one, or actually, sorry, that's the wrong again. Regular one facing outwards, and then another temporary block there. No, that's not right either. What is it? There we go. Like so. Oh. There we go. So that's the fan blades complete. Oh, we've now got a white wool. We can drag this back again five. Although, actually, let's continue with the inside of the engine. I forgot about that. So we got our stone brick stairs. And slabs, so just create that row of stone brick slabs across, circle of stone brick stairs, like so, and then another row of stone brick slabs. And then you want to get out your diorite stairs again real quick, and just place a circle of that, and then continue that back, just like so. That's the full interior of the engine, and then we can just drag this white bolt back again, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like so. That's the other side as well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then with your slabs, just create that row of three on either side. Just like so. And again, now for some small details. We've got your acacia button, stone button, and jungle sign. Acacia button on that second block back with a stone button behind it. And again on the other side, acacia button on that second block back with a jungle sign right above it. And that should do it for, actually, another detail I forgot. On the inner engine, that button is on the first cobblestone block. On the outer one, it's on the last one right there. So just keep that in mind. And then now for the just outtake or exhaust of the engine real quick. Here we go. So again, we've got that half cobblestone, half black block. Place your nether brick slab across from that, and then acacia trap doors on the top and bottom. All right, so that is it for the left side engines. Now we're gonna be doing the right ones, and then we'll convert that them over to the other engine type right there, which I can't remember the name of, GP something, 7200s, I believe. Okay, gotta switch my materials again here. Let's see. happy about, right? Okay, so starting off from this inner engine pylon here, you've got your three blocks that come forward, and then your smooth stone coming out. Extend it inwards by one, and then create that same circle that you've now done twice already. Like so. Now we can do the... Alright, once we do... So, just so that you know, so the little gray detail on the underside of the engine does not switch sides. So we'll be doing that on the same side, even though this engine is on the other side of the aircraft. So, we're going to place that on the inside side this time, with your white wool right there. And then, let's see, that would be two blocks back. Purple stairs, and then purple slabs. And we can do the top of the engine real quick as well. Just three blocks back, purple stair, purple slab. And now we can do our engine fans and interior. So get out your polished blackstone stairs again. And then again with the fan blades, those are also not going to be flipped on the other side. So all of the engines, actually, the fan blades rotate the same way, even though they're on the opposite side from each other. So here, just start that off with the upside down facing outwards this time. And then a regular stair facing outwards, regular stair facing inwards, and regular stair, or upside down stair facing inwards. Coming back from that with our stone brick slabs, we've got that row of two sort of in between layers there, circle of stone brick stairs, and then our stone brick slabs once again. And then you can get out your diorite stairs and just place that two block long little cylinder thing we've got. And now for the sides of the engine here, we've got just our row of five, like so, and we can do that on the other side as well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then extend our slabs back three blocks, just like so. And oh, I just forgot to put the trapdoors down there, so just delete some blocks real quick. Do that. So you got your birch trapdoor and iron trapdoor out. Iron trapdoor under that coal ore. And then a birch trapdoor is on the other three blocks right there. Let me just replace that real quick. And then now for the detailing, if we just fly over to the other engine real quick, you can see that the, so the other details do flip. It's just that that fan blade and that little thing down there do not. So it's a little bit confusing to do. So we'll do it, from the details now on, they will not be flipped. So, go to the sign, stone button, and acacia button. And then we've got our, let's see, what did I do on the other side? I forgot. Oh, yes, okay, so, on the inside, we've got our acacia button two blocks back on that white wall there. And then our jungle sign on the inside. And same thing on the other side with the acacia button, but just with a stone button behind. And just to finish off the exhaust now, get out your nether brick slab and acacia trapdoor. Acacia across from the cobblestone, and then just those trapdoors on either side. That's it for the third engine, and now for this final one here. Then we'll convert it to the other engine type. Just gotta replace my materials once again here. Does take a little while. Let's see what we need. That should be good. So coming out from this trapdoor right here, you've got our three blocks with a smooth stone in front of it. Come inwards with that and create the circle. Just like so. And then jungle trapdoors on the top half like so. On the inside, we can do the top of the engine with three white wool blocks back. Purple stair, purple slab. On the underside, we've got our, our iron iron or coal ore and iron trapdoor. And then, white wool around it with the birch trapdoors. One more row of white wool, purple stairs, and then slabs. For the fan blade, one final time here. We've got, I keep forgetting how to do this. There we go. Okay, so we've got upside down, blackstone, polished blackstone stair facing outwards, regular blackstone stair facing outwards, regular blackstone stair facing inwards, and upside down blackstone stair facing inwards. And continuing back with the inside of the engine, we've got our stone brick slabs in between layers, stone brick stair circle here, oops, like so, another row of stone brick slabs, and then a diorite stair cylinder, as we have been doing. And then now just for the outside of the engine real quick, five rows back, one, two, three, four, five, and then you've got your three purple slabs. And same thing on the outside of the cross section of the engine, does look pretty cool. One, two, three, four, five, and your three purple slabs. Alright, and now for the final details. We've got your acacia button, white wool, purple stairs, acacia trapdoor, and nether brick slab. Got that jungle sign on the inside on that block right there, with the acacia button below it, and then that acacia button with the stone button right behind it. And then we've just got our nether brick slab across from that cobblestone slab, and the acacia trapdoors across from it. And I believe, if I'm not missing any details there, oh, we do got to do the buttons on the pylons here. So that first one for the inner one, and the last one for the outer one. And that'll do it for the Trent 900s. Now we will convert them to the GP7200s, I think. I'll check before I do it again. But yeah, nice job on completing the Trents. Alright, so now to convert the engines into the Engine Alliance GP7200s. Real quick, if you haven't heard of the Engine Alliance, that's because it was not really a real company. It's a combination of, I believe, General Electric and Pratt & Whitney. The engine was originally created, or they were the like subsidiary of the two companies. It was originally created, I believe, because of the 747... like 400 or 500X project, but after that was canceled, they really had nothing to do. So once the A380 came into service, or became, you know, like an idea, they created the Engine Alliance GP7200, which I believe uses most of the same parts from that engine for the 747 500X that, you know, never came to be. It does use the mostly the exact same cowling as the what is it, the Trent 900s. Just some small details in the exhaust, the actual like innards of the engine. So yeah. So we'll just start with this left side inner engine here. We can just delete these fan blades real quick and replace them with our endstone brick stairs. So that same shape as before. I won't explain it this time because you've already done it four times. By the way, if you only want to build the Trent 900s, just skip this part. And if you only want to build the GP7200s, watch the Trent 900 bit of the video first, and then we will convert the Trent 900s into the GP7200s because they're so similar. But anyways, yes, convert the blackstone into endstone. We can delete these two buttons here, and delete the button on the other side, I believe. Yes, and then, sorry, I didn't take pictures of these. So just doing this from memory. And then on the underside of the engine, we'll just delete these trapdoors. And I believe it is a jungle button right there, as you can see over there in the other engines. And then, just for one added detail, on this first slab right here, if you do have rolled it, we can just place a temporary block there with a acacia button on the side, get your stick, slash rebel 0, copy that over, and just paste that in. If you don't have rolled it, that's a very small detail, so it doesn't really matter. But yeah, there's actually no details on the inside of the engine other than that little airfoil extension there. So yeah, we'll now do the same thing on this engine over here. So we've got these chapters deleted and just jungle button right there. As you can see over there, though, is that... I'm wondering if I accidentally put that on the wrong block, let's see. No, that should be right. Okay, so I delete those two things right there. And again, we can just, because that button is still in our inventory, we can just flip that over still. And then we can replace the fan blades with the endstone brick stairs. Again, that same pattern. There we go. And just delete that acacia button on the inside. And now we can just go onto the other side. Delete that right there. And then we can roll edit over that button again. Just on that same slab there. And just delete those two details. And then delete those fan blades again. And end stone brick stair. Circle like that. And I believe... Yes, okay. Just got a little bit confused there. Okay, just delete that again. And then we've got... I don't need to do that. There we go. Replace those end stone brick stairs again. There we go. And then just delete those two. And... Oh yeah, I forgot to do the trapdoors on these, I believe. So just do that, and that button right there. Just that, and there we go. So that's most of the engine done. The one final detail is that we're going to be switching this diorite to a... Oh, what was it? Is it stone? I believe it is stone. Yes, stone brick stairs. So it's the same pattern. Just delete these eight stairs in here, and we can do that same pattern right there. And then we can just keep doing that on all the engines. Shouldn't be too hard here. Just get that exact same pattern, just out of stone, like so. Here we go. And just like so, and then the last engine right here. Alright. And that's it. So that is all you need to convert the Trent 900s into those GP7200s. Again, very similar engine, so it really does not take much. Basically just the exhaust color difference and details. But yeah, now we will be moving on to the interior, I believe. So yeah. Okay, so starting on the interior, just before we start, I want to let you know that there will be a lot of cuts in this section because the interior is very complicated. So first, I'm just going to do the cockpit, then we'll do some of the bottom floor, finish that, top floor, all that stuff. So yeah, so this first cut is just going to be the cockpit. And just like this little entrance area. So you can just, and then also for the floor, we can start by just covering this whole area with slabs. So might take a second here. But yeah, this is kind of the just, you know, the floor of the interior. These areas of the cargo hold, you can just place a block there and bring that back just to make sure there's no exposed areas in the cargo holds. So like for instance there, just to make sure you can't see the rest of the interior inside the cargo hold. Should be good. So, going back up to the front of the plane, right at the entrance, you can get your spruce trapdoor out and just close that one right against the door there. Let me just look at my notes real quick here. got to load in again. Okay, so on this block right here on the left, just place one diorite stair, and then a 2x3 of smooth stone right there. You can place a, or actually we can fill in this area with diorite real quick for the raised floor of the pilot area in the cockpit. And then we can get a, not in there, we can get a dark oak trapdoor, and just place two of those for the overhead panels right there. Inside the cockpit, if you get your red glazed terracotta, stone button, lever, and andesite stairs. Red glazed terracotta, it's going to go right at the front here, and you're just going to place it around until you find the one with the blue top and black bottom. That's just to suggest that kind of like grayish blue thing that the Airbus cockpits kind of do. Let's see, the cockpit seats come back here, and then just for a very simple throttle quadrant here, just have a lever here, and then, I should have thought about doing this. Okay, we're going to delete these real quick so that I can get a button in there. And just like so, so you just got that button on there, and then andesite stairs back where they were. I'm going to have to roll edit this back so I can get back out of there. But yeah, that'll be the finished cockpit. Very small, but it adds a little bit of detail. Now you can get out your birch door, gray banner, and spruce trapdoor, and I think that's all we need. And just birch door right on the stair. Is that going to work? Maybe not. I forget if you can place doors on stairs. There we go. Okay, so door right there, and then world edit a stair over, like so. And then a gray banner right here with a spruce trapdoor right at the bottom. We can also, real quick, I think there is, I don't have a picture of this, but I do remember a little bit. If you get out your dead tube coral fan, and just place, ooh, actually that's interesting. Okay, I'll have to look at that. So yeah, we won't do that yet. But yeah, that's going to be the first little cut here, just this little area. Okay, starting again here, we're going to first do the staircase that goes up to the second floor. So place a diorite stair there, just with a one block gap between that center smooth stone. And another one right there, and one final last one here. The floor height of the second floor is right there, so that's where we'll stop that. We're now going to get out our dead coral fans here, and I believe, yes, so just place any blocks you want in these here. Actually, that one's going to be a white wool, and then I think there's a smooth stand zones there, facing backwards, upside down right there, and then dead brain coral fans here, and then we're going to world edit these with some temporary blocks onto here. And there, and then same thing on the other side here, like so, and just select these, paste them over. Don't paste them onto that top one though, because that one is going to be an upside down stair like this. And then we can just continue that across like that. We've also got our tube coral fan, put one of those there, and then select them, and then also place them on these stairs. You're gonna have to roll those on because you can't place those on stairs, just like so. And then what we can do is by taking this pattern that I'm gonna build here real quick, like so, that sort of pattern, we can bring that back. That's the pattern for most of the aircraft. There are some exceptions, for instance, when there's doors, it just is a slab all the way across because there's no overhead bins or there are doors. These are to represent the overhead bins, and also in some other places, but I'm not exactly sure of all those locations. So currently, you can just do this at the doors, and then for anything specific, we can go into that later. So just like that for now. Yeah, and then I'm not exactly sure what it does at the end, but I think it's that. So yeah, come back up to the front here. Just bring these slabs all the way back. Just like so. And we'll just bring it to this last door, because I think it's about where I don't know what is going on anymore. Is. That should be blocks. Just like so. And then I can replace the door ones with slabs. Just like so. And then we can just go down the center real quick as well as right here. Let's see. Just like so. And then purple blocks again down the center, except for where there are doors, like so. And I think this, yes, this door here, actually, I do remember, there should be stairs facing backwards, like so. Not a exactly sure where the middle, but I know for these ones that's how it looks. Just like so. And then I think the rest of them are just normal. Just like so. And that is the base of sort of like this lower floor area. We'll get to the upper floor later. That's a little complicated because, as you can see, it's only three blocks wide, which means that all the seats are in the middle here. Because, I mean, we could put them here and here, but the A380 does not have a middle aisle, so we thought it would be better to represent it with the seats in the middle, even though that does only give us one row of seats. If you may remember from the fuselage portion, there's a lot of stairs back here, and that is for the crew rest areas, which we'll get into as well. So yeah, we can place lots of vertical slabs around here, and yeah, stuff like that. So, coming back up to the front of the aircraft here. Okay, so continuing on with the interior now. First, we're just going to come up to the front here and just block in this area here, which I forgot to do. I believe that's how that goes. Looks like that would have to stay open. Maybe that even isn't there. Huh, okay. I can't really remember how that goes. I'll come back to that if it's wrong later. I discovered that this is actually covered up right there, and I think it's actually this one that's deleted right there, just in the center there, the one behind these two doors. And then now moving on with the first class seat, or seats. So we're going to start with the outside ones and then move into the center. So we've got a little bit of world edit going on here. So we're going to need this upside down smooth stones that are facing backwards, cornered off so that from the side it's just a regular block. And you can paste that in here. So it should look like that. If you don't roll it, that's fine. Probably just do it like that. And then we're going to put a smooth stone slab on top of that. Moving backwards again, just skip this first block, and then a crimson stair, which is sort of a gray plank texture in the Aeroteam pack. You can just switch it out with another gray block, it doesn't really matter which. And then a smooth stone stair behind that, and that's going to be the same one as this. We can just paste that over again. This stair is also going to be edited, just like so, just like that. Just to create sort of like a little privacy barrier like some of the first class A380s do. And now we can place a quartz slab on top of that crimson stair and a, let's see, smooth stone slab on top of the smooth stone stair. And then on this quartz slab, we're going to roll that in a jungle button onto there. So just place a temporary block there. And just like that. And let's see here. That should be good for that. I am just going to, let's see, yeah, I'm just gonna, there goes that. I have to replace that now. There we go. Yeah, okay. So I'm just gonna build another one of those real quick, except for that for the back part of it, we're just gonna use, I don't have it in my inventory right now, I'm just gonna use regular, I can't really get rid of anything, regular smooth stone, just like so. And I think I have a picture of this. Oh no, I didn't take a picture of that galley, okay. Alright, so that's probably good for now. Yeah, because I think I'm like 99% sure that's just blocks. So then, quartz slab right there, and then just corner off that's there. If you can't do that, that's fine. You can just leave it regular. And then we've got that button again. It's just another temporary block, just like that. And then we can do the same thing on the other side. So just like so. And then we're gonna have to, let's see, actually I'm gonna do this over here so it doesn't touch that. Actually I'm gonna have to, there we go. Just copy that over. And just like so. And then we've got the crimson stairs there and there. And then we just want them to be cornered off. So we got that one. Like so. This one right here. And yeah, that'll break that. So I'm gonna have to replace that. If you can't tell, there's a lot of world edit in this section. So if you don't have world edit, if you can have it, I would highly suggest it. Great mod, like literally the best thing ever. If you are on Bedrock or something that doesn't have that, just kind of follow along as best as you can. So for instance, you can just use a regular stair here instead of this like cornered off one. Same here, although maybe instead of this you want to use a full block instead, because it basically the only difference is like that little cutout, so just using a full block there will look better than having a stair and having this also cut out. So yeah, just a full block there, regular stair there, and then just no button, and that's pretty much it. Moving into the center here, we've got our crimson stairs again, and then an upside down stair facing backwards with jungle trapdoors on the side. Did that break that? I think it did. It's really hard to see. Yeah, it did. So just replace those. Wait, did this one break too? It did. Okay, I'm gonna have to replace that too. Yeah, that's the problem with World Edit, is that like you just touch it like in like the singular wrong way and then everything breaks, so you gotta be careful. Here we go. Okay. And then for these center areas, it's pretty much the same thing with that slab there, quartz, and then another button. Just select it from there. And I believe there are more jungle trapdoors there. So I'm just gonna select that, place this there, and then just paste it back. Same with this side, select that, put that there, and then paste this back. Oh, it didn't break that time. Okay, and then that's one row of seats, and then we can just do the same thing again here. So except for it'll be the same with like this is the back instead of the other one. Okay, so crimson stair, jungle trapdoors on the side, and then that back over like so, and I believe that is all it. First class section is very small because I mean normally you'd be able to fit a lot more seats in here, but you know micro blocks are pretty thick, so unfortunately we can't do that. If we ever do a 1.5 to 1 A380 tutorial, there will be a lot more seats in this area. This is just going off one of the this is no like not like a specific airlines first class. Like I'm pretty sure Emirates says first class like on the upper row, not the lower one, so you might want to even make your own custom interior if you're making one of those airlines. This is just one of like the default ones from the Airbus APM for the A380, which is what we use to find all of our dimensions and everything, and this is just one of the interiors provided, so that's what we did. As for colors, we kind of just mixed together lots of things to make like a pretty accurate one, but it's, yeah, like because we don't want to like have like say like, oh yeah, this is for an Emirates interior, and then you want to build like Lufthansa or something, and you know, can't do that. So anyways, yeah, this is just like a default one. It'll pretty much work with any airline. I mean, it shouldn't really have any problems, but yeah. Okay, moving on here. We've got more blocks right there and there. And then, yes, I think that breaks right there because, or actually, let's see. No, there wouldn't be a break there. I don't have any. Okay. There we go. And then, so what we're going to do is have a trapdoor right here. Trapdoor's on the side, down. And then a stair facing like this. Trapdoors, oops, not like that. Like so. And trapdoors on the back like this. That creates a nice little sink effect. And then we can just get a stone button. Place that on there. And then just for one final one, I believe it's just blocks here. If any of these are not correct, I'll come back to them and correct them later. But this is like the basic gist of it. So, you know, shouldn't have too much problems. Too many problems, not too much problems. Okay, moving into the economy section. We now have, or like economy, premium, economy, business. They're all the same, pretty much. So it doesn't really matter too much. We've got our blue stairs and slabs, like so. If you can't use these, maybe use, what's that new block? I know we retextured it, but it should be something. I can't find it. It's the, no, not that. It's, you know, one of the green ones, I don't know. I forget the default blocks, but yeah, it's, you should be able to use that instead, or just any color, it doesn't really matter. Anyways, the basic seat design, as you've probably seen on this channel before, is a stair with a slab on it to represent, like, the headrest. So you can place one of these on either side. And then, going back from here, we're gonna have, let's see, 5 full rows of seats in all, not including this. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like so. Then we can just fill this in. I'm only going to do one side for now because it's going to be pretty hard to move around once they're all in, so I'm just going to do it there. And then we have, let's see, I know for this one, we've got a spruce stone here, and then if you find your doors, a birch door backwards like so, and that's just for the a laboratory there, I believe. And that is on both sides. Okay, so for this one, these are cut out, but this center one is not, so just continue that like so. And I think that's all the breaks there are there. I don't have any other pictures of it, unfortunately. But yeah, that should be good. Okay, and then there's a chair there, and then coming forward from that, a hole right here. Like so, and then just place these on there. This one, yeah. Just like so. All right. Moving backwards now, we've got more seats. If you couldn't tell, we're just going to be starting these seats right here. I believe that's. Okay, that's actually a 2-block break right behind the door, I believe, so I'm just going to place these in and make sure this is spaced correctly. Yeah, because we've got that, and then a smooth stone block, yes, okay, with a tube coral fan right there. So that's kind of like the basic thing for this area. So there should be a 2-block break between this door and right here. Just place those back, smooth stone right there. And a dead tube coral fan. I did take better pictures of this area because it gets quite complex. So in the center here, what we're gonna do is have an upside down stair facing backwards. Jungle trapdoors on either side of that. Jungle trapdoors up from that as well, like so. And one on the top like that. Cover that up on the back with trapdoors as well. There we go. And then we've got pretty similar, just with that sink design, same one that we used earlier. Like this. It's quite hard to build with the all the trapdoors. Like so, and then we've also got the that trapdoor on the top right there. This one, that's there, should not be there. There should be just a slab there and a full block there. So there should be a stair here to like line up with these vertical slabs, and then just a block break here. And then we can get out a button to go right there. That's for the sink. And then it should be the same on the other side with most of this stuff. We've got our, it doesn't have, go. These, and then just like so. And then let's see. Okay, so this is where the seats start being like offset from each other. Like so. So I think they should be like that. Let me just place the slabs on top of them. And it should be, yes, okay, so that lines up like so. We do place a rest there because this is kind of where this fuselage starts to, you know, come up into itself. And if we did a stair right there, you know, you'd be able to see out. So yeah, unfortunately, we do have to put a white stair there, but it shouldn't be too big of a deal. Because yeah, it looks pretty good. So yeah. And then just continue going with your stairs here, just like so. And then we've got these center ones here, and that could just come back on. That should be on top of that green stair right there that we placed earlier for the bulk cargo hold. And then let's see, now we're going to get out your polished andesite. It's actually right there. Stone button, trapdoor, smooth stone block, birch door. Just getting out a couple materials here. Oh yeah, and the stair is also needed, I believe. So just behind this door, place a 3-block tall thing of polished andesite with a button right there. And then you've got a birch door right there. Make sure that's on that block, not this one. And then we've got, I have a trapdoor right there. Trapdoors along like that. And then smooth stone right there with another trapdoor. And this is where the back spiral staircase is. So we did manage to get the staircase in. It is a little bit cramped, but basically this stair is going to have to be bolted in. And there's one here, I believe. And, oh yes, this one is actually not a full block, but a stair like that. So this stair right here will be cornered off like so. Just like that. And this stair here will be, what we can do is cornered off like that. And then if we just replace that block with a block of smooth stone, just right there. And then I believe there's smooth stone there as well. Forgive me, I don't have great pictures of this area, so I'm gonna do another cut here and get some better images of this. I think this should come back one block more here, so we'll do that real quick. And yeah, that should be, I'm also gonna fill in this area. Yeah, but this should be the basic gist of, you know, most of the lower deck, and the upper deck is going to be, I think, even more complicated because the crew rest areas mine put a lot of time into getting those looking accurate, so I want to make sure I capture those. Yeah, that should be most of it done here. And then I believe there is smooth stone along here. There isn't, again, I will come back and correct it, but for now, I'm pretty sure that's what it is. Okay, I'm gonna do another cut real quick and get some better pictures. Alright, now moving on to the upper deck here. First off, I just want to change out this little area here, because that should actually be white, not smooth stone. Just like here. And also, this stair should be, I think I did it wrong originally. I'm just gonna have to find some empty space to do this. It should be, I believe, actually no, it should not be like that. It should, that's how it was before, I think. It should be like this. And then just cover that up, just like that. Okay, so moving up, we have over here, you can get out your, jungle trapdoors and just place those over those first three windows. Delete these three slabs. This, that last one is going to become a block, and then you can raise up these as well. And then these two are going to be brain coral fans. So just like that. And then on the bottom, we're going to do dead tube coral. That doesn't work there. Just like so. Okay, now we've got, I believe, a block here and there. And this is the hard part of this layer. Okay, so might have to do another cut here because this is very complicated. Okay, actually wait, I might have gotten it here. Okay, actually this block here is gonna be a spruce stone. And then we've got one block here. Yes, like that. And then you're gonna get out your light gray bed. Yeah, I think that's not a thing that's been seen in an aircraft tutorial before. I just place two of those on top of each other, like so, with iron trapdoors on either end, just like that. And then, let's see here, we've got where this door is. These trapdoors, you can stack two of those like that, and then there's going to be a birch door on the other side, like so. And then we have another birch door, I believe. Or actually, yeah, so we've got where are the trapdoors? Two more trapdoors right there, with another birch door here. And then I believe this is dead tube coral fans all along here, so just place some temporary blocks here, like so, and then just ripple those over. I'm gonna do a cut real quick, because I'm pretty sure that's correct, but not entirely sure. Actually, wait, I do have a picture of that, don't I? Yes, I have to take a picture of that. Okay. Okay, so these three should be, but this last one should be trapdoors. There we go. And then that should also come over here, and also on these two right here. And that should be good. I believe that is correct. Yep, that looks good. So that's the crew rest areas, and now we'll do the upper deck. Alright, continuing on, I just checked the crew rest areas, and it is completely correct, actually. I only made one small mistake. Instead of trapdoors here, you're just going to want full blocks. And then there should also be a door right there that works like so. And then we can just make that a full block right there. Same with that one. Okay, moving forward from that, we've got our, the beginning, and actually that should be, fix it real quick, it should be like that, there we go. Okay, now moving on, we've just got five rows of economy, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, just slabs on top of those. And then a little area where we can, oh, actually, what's going on there? Okay, so I think that is, because of this upper deck is much smaller, we just use those to do little breaks in between sections there. So that should be all that is needed right there. Moving forward from that, we've got our a lot of first class area. So let's switch out our materials real quick. Get out our crimson stairs. Keep those down there. Crimson stairs, jungle trapdoor, quartz slab, and jungle button. And that should be good. And we've just got our first one of those right here. We've got a stair with trapdoors on either side, as well as the back. Quartz slab on top, and then a jungle button rolled edited on to that headrest right there. And we can just keep going forward with these. So I'm just going to place out all the stairs, and then we can come forward. So that should be 8 in all. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And now we can just... I'm actually just going to copy this one. And let's see. Yeah, if I just do that. And then... select without that there, select that as the second position, and slash slash stack 7, that should work. Ah, but that is copied over. Okay, delete those real quick. And that should be, that didn't work very well, did it? Okay, yeah, because I copied it wrong. Okay, we'll do 1. And then, yes, the second position should be there. There we go. And that should be the correct number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And then we can just delete that one right there. Now we've got a little bit of a little galley area, so we can actually replace that jungle trapdoor. Another one on top of it. And, we can just delete that. And then get your tube coral fan out, and just two of those right there. And then we've got, let's see, what would that be? Okay, so we got a smooth stone full block, I believe. Two of those right there, with the tube corals on those. And then for our trap doors, we've got one set along the walls right there. Oh. So, and right there, and then also in front of the door as well, just like so. And then it's quite hard to place. There we go. Just like that. And that is all for that little area, and then we can actually, yeah, we're gonna get out these again and just block those up, just like so. And actually, I'm gonna run back and do that real quick because I didn't do that before, just like so. And then coming to the front here, we just got a couple final details. I did look at this, and it's actually supposed to be a stair here. Like so, and then another stair, that could be any blocks, it doesn't really matter. Another stair there, I think another stair here as well. And then that exits out into here. Like so, just cover all this up. Like so, and then we've got, and that doesn't work, does it? Yeah, you gotta go like that. Oh, I know the problem, because I started the stairs on the wrong level. So you actually kind of want to delete those. Sorry about that. And then just block this up again. And the stairs like that. There we go. Okay, so yeah, now you should be able to walk down it completely fine. And then what we're gonna have is a, it's gonna be the same thing as down there with the spruce trapdoor and a gray banner, like so. And then a birch door just right there. And pluck that off. Okay, moving backwards now for that final layer of seats. We've got just three more seats, it looks like. So this first one is just gonna be here. I got rid of my cords. Just like so. And then we've got another one here and there. And then we can roll that at some tube corals right there. We'll do that in a second. Just like so. And then there's some temporary blocks there. And paste those over. And then now get your tube corals again. I think these are in the right direction, so you just select those over actually. And then, oh no, they, are they? Yes, I think they are. Try it out. There's two temporary blocks there. And yep, you just want two of those right there. And that should do it for the upper deck. Not super hard once we got past that crew rest area, but that place is really quite the pain. So yeah, that door I think would normally be, oops, not what I meant to do. This door will be normally closed in flight, I believe, and I guess that wasn't closed, so that's fine. Let's do the thing. Sometimes doors do not work on the server, and you kind of like warp back through it like I was before. But yeah. And then I also discovered that actually should not be there. I messed that area up a little bit there. We've got, instead of that, let's see, yes, so we've got a stair with, actually not like that, what was it, there's trapdoors on the side, like so, so you can put those down, and that just goes up again. Oh yes, it was just a door, so, just like so. And then just a door right there. And I think that's just for another bathroom or something. And on the inside, let's get your smooth stone again and just walk that up. Ooh. Not very good at building today if you haven't noticed yet. There we go. All right, that should be it for the interior. I don't think I made any other little mistakes. So yeah. And, oh yes, actually there was one more thing. On the side of all these, there should be trapdoors. Like so. That one's got it. Yeah, I think all these got it, so I think it was just that one. But yeah, that should do it for the interior. So we're getting very close to the end of this tutorial, luckily, because this interior was a pain to record, and I'm sure it was very hard to build, so sorry if any of the parts were confusing. If you had any questions, just ask in the comments, and hopefully I can answer you, maybe provide a picture or something. But yeah, it shouldn't be too hard, hopefully. So yeah, now onto the landing gear. Okay, so to start on the final part of the tutorial, the landing gear, we're first going to come up to the nose gear right here, or the nose gear doors, rather, and just delete these two right here. And now we're going to add a quartz stair upside down facing outwards, and a quartz slab just right there. And do the same on the other side, just like so. Now you can get out your stone brick wall and just place one here and one here. And then above that, what we're going to have is two rolled-out levers. So we're going to have just a temporary block there, and you can place that lever on it. And then down here, another temporary block with a lever like so. Select that and paste it over. And just like so. Now we're going to roll that at these walls, and by doing so, we're just going to create this shape. So you kind of create this upside down T parallel to the aircraft, like so, and just paste both of those over, so it should look like that. Now we just have a temporary block here with a, oh, I don't have a torch, there it is, with a torch right here, and we can just replace that over. And okay, that didn't break. And then for just a final detail, right here, lever on the back, just like so. And for the actual wheel, if you do not outroll it, what you can do is, or the pack for that matter, if you don't have the pack either, just a regular block of wool right there, and that'll look pretty good. However, if you do have rolled it and the pack, what we can do is get out your dead fire coral fan, place a temporary black block or any block right there, and a dead fire coral fan, and then just the other side and replace that over. And that just is a little bit more realistic. It looks a little bit better. So yeah. Moving back now to the main gears. First, what we're going to do is, let me just look at my notes here, because this is a pretty complicated area. We've got to make some changes to the wing as well. So, after this block here, these two, we're going to delete those as well as these. And instead here, we can just bring these up here. Like so, place that there, and then now what we're going to get is a tube coral fan, like so. If you don't have those, it's fine, not too big of a deal there. We're then going to, let's see, don't really have great pictures of this. So you've got, actually I'm going to start in the center gear, because those will be a little bit easier to do. So first, you're just going to delete these, let's see, these three quartz stairs right here, ignoring this last one. So just those three right there. And that should put you under these walls here. Now going up in here, you might remember building this earlier, we're going to change this stair and corner it off like this. So get out your quartz stairs and just make that a cornered off one, and we could just paste that in. And that's really the only change that we need to make. Now we can bring these down like so, and what we're going to want to do is make them like this so that they're connecting to this side only, just like so. And there we go. And then now we can get our black wool out and just place down your 2x3 of that, and that should be starting, let me see here, this should be the top right of it, so it should be there. And then you're going to want to get your stone button, levers, don't have those, and let's see that. What coral is that? Your bubble coral, I believe. Yes. So you just place the stone buttons on the side here. Levers on the back flipped facing forward like so. Temporary block right there with a bubble coral fan on the side of it. And then you can just paste the other side in right there. And then we've got temporary blocks here with a lever like so, and you can just paste that over. And that is the center gear right there. I'm going to build the other side as well because it's pretty easy to do. So we just have our 2x3 with the buttons on it, and then delete these right there. Which one would that be? Go like that, paste that over, there we go, and then just replace that there. Now we got our stone brick walls there, just place those there, and make your little square again. That can go there, that can go there, and then on the back of the wheels, you got the two levers flipped facing forwards, and then I'm just going to copy these over. So again, with those dead bubble coral fan, I believe it is, or just regular bubble coral, not dead. And then it's just temporary blocks right there with those levers on it as well, just like so. And that is the center gear of the A380. Looks a little bit weird with just the center gear there. So now for the outer gear. So yes, as I mentioned beforehand, you should have already done that. The center gear comes down. Let's see, it would be, I don't have a good side view of it. So it comes, I think it should be right here. And you're gonna want to put your stone buttons on all the sides like that. Let's see here, you've got to do the landing gear door, which I'll do real quick. You've got a slab, the tube coral, regular smooth stone, and that will be a, let me just check that real quick. Okay, yes, so a regular smooth stone top slab right there, smooth stone on top of that, and then we can just replace that with another smooth stone. Dead tube coral in front of that, and then replace this with a stair, I believe, like so. And then on the back here, we're just going to want to have a smooth stone slab, no stair right there. And yeah, that will be that. Now for the landing gear leg. We've got, trying to figure out, alright, so starting here, we've got a walls here, and then a, I'm trying to figure out if this is a wall, okay, that's a vertical slab, so a, one of these bubble coral right here, and that can just be pasted on right there, like that. Now these stone brick walls are also going to be world edited. This one right here, the bottom one, just place a cross with one in the center like so, and that is for that one. This one over here is going to be, I believe, pretty much the same thing, just, yes, so it'll be the same thing just without that side, so you can just paste that over again like so. Now for some more details on that. This right here, I'm just gonna place a temporary block there, and then get a lever. Oh, only need one. And we can just replace that over. Gonna get a button right here. So we can just, again, place that over. And then that's also got a button on the back of it. We just place that there. Just like so. And then this lever here is actually going to be connecting up into there. So right here, we can just place a temporary block. Oh, okay, well that sucks. All right, well, because we have to deal with all this again. Replace that right there. Well, now that you know how to do it, I'm not going to explain it again. I can just do this really quickly. Nope. Wrong one. Go like that, and like that. Okay, so not placing a block there because that will break this whole thing. I'm going to select that and paste it in right here. And then to get a lever right there, what I'm going to do is use the slash move command. So I'm going to delete this real quick. I'm not going to do it there. I'm going to do it right here. Delete that slab real quick. Get your axe out and select that, just that one block, and then do slash slash move in the direction you want it to go, just like that. And then we can replace that right there. Okay, that should be almost everything, if not everything. I just gotta, oh yes, and then for one final detail, just a lever right there, and of course it cannot place without it breaking, so just just put that right there, just like so, and that should be the tire landing gear. I'm just going to do a final check. It looks to be so. Just deleting all this. You've now finished the A380. Congratulations on completing this Aeroteam tutorial. Thanks for choosing an Aeroteam video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to use this Airbus A380 in any public project as long as you give the Aeroteam proper credit. If you did build this tutorial, please let us know by tagging us on Twitter at AeroteamMC or share it with us in the Discord. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing. We do all sorts of Minecraft tutorials and showcases, and you can be the first to see them when they come out. Again, I really do hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I'm X13, and thanks for watching.